so good. I wanna hold her, wanna hold her tight. Get teenage kicks right through the night. I'm gonna call her on the telephone. Have her over cause I'm all alone. I need excitement, oh I need it bad. And it's the best I've ever had. I wanna hold her, wanna hold her tight. Get teenage kicks right through. Street. Another girl in the neighborhood. Wish she was mine, she looks so good. I wanna hold her, wanna hold her tight. Get teenage kicks right through the night. I'm gonna call her on the telephone. Have her over cause I'm all alone. I need excitement, oh I need it bad. And it's the best I've ever had.
Hi, Deuce. How you doing?
Right, yourself?
Yeah, not too bad. Did you get my telegram with my report?
I sure did. Thank you very much.
Was that all right? Was it? I was trying to remember exactly what happened, you know, to give as much detail.
No, it is good enough. I really do appreciate it.
Yeah, no problem. I hope I'm not going to get anybody in trouble.
No, I'm just gonna see who's telling the truth, who's lying.
Right, yeah, getting a fuller picture of what actually happened.
No one's gonna get in trouble from this.
No, I think, you know, he was just probably just trying to, I suppose, show off a little bit, but you know, he should have stayed with us, so we were a bit safer, you know.
And we'll get a stern talking to.
Yeah. Multiple. Yeah. Okay.
Thank you. Thank you once again.
No problem. Happy to help, you know. I'm not going to be on duty. I might be on duty for a little bit, but I'm supposed to be seeing friends today. So if a call comes in, I'll take it, you know, until they turn up.
Very well.
Yeah. You stay safe.
I will. I'll be coming back momentarily here.
Okay. No problem. I'm just going to go and get changed.
All right. We will, all right?
Yeah, you too. See you in a bit.
Hello.
Hello. Hello there. Is that you, Hal? that squeaky thing?
How are you, mister?
Yeah, I'm all right. Now, puss.
Morning, friend.
Morning.
Thank you.
Hello, you two. How you doing?
I'm living. How are you?
I'm all right, thank you.
Good.
Oh, Kat, how you doing? Deep in thought, yeah. Okay.
Sorry?
I was going to say, how are you doing?
Oh, no, I said hello, how are you? I'm so sorry.
That's all right now, I'm fine.
It's okay. Oh, no.
That's all right. I was going to come with you yesterday, but you all sort of went off and I'm...
Oh, no, I didn't realise.
No, it's all right. You all seemed in like, you know, it's like in a bit of a rush, so... Yeah. But, I'm off...
Oh, you're off duty today?
Yeah, just like my friend Flo, she's coming over. So she's going to tell me about her Guelma trip. Yeah. Would you like a chocolate milk?
I'm all right, but thank you, though. I appreciate it.
You'll definitely have one, won't you?
I will take one, and I will also take a hug, please.
Okay.
Thank you. Just had to throw my clipboard down on the ground for the chocolate milk.
Oh, how you feeling today? You a bit happier?
Well, I didn't sleep great, so there's that. And I think I maybe got like 2 hours sleep.
Really?
Wrong. Yeah. But it'll be okay.
Yeah, it's hard, isn't it?
It's not the end of the world, is it?
No. But, you know, you got to get your rest. I know what I'm like. If I don't get enough sleep, I'll get all grouchy. And
I'm very grumpy today, but I'm hiding it very well.
All confused as well.
Yeah.
Like a tit in a trance.
Exactly. I have fizzy fingers today. I'm all over the place.
Oh, blimey. Have you ever had that, Kat? Have you ever had fizzy fingers?
I don't think so.
Like, you know when you bump your elbow, you get fizzy fingers?
Oh, like fuzz. Cause
yeah.
The feeling of fuzz, yeah.
Yeah.
Yep. I think my family, they call that pins and needles.
Oh, right.
I prefer fizzy fingers
yeah.
for some reason.
Yeah, yeah, like if you get frightened, you get like fizzy fingers because your adrenaline's pumping.
Mm. Yeah.
You just got to take it steady today. You know, don't overdo it.
Yeah, I don't think I'm going to get on duty today because I'm going to be very grumpy and I don't want anyone to see me grumpy.
No.
That's all right.
I'm dark dusk today, not bright dawn.
Oh, God.
Kat, I'll need to...
I'm kidding.
I need to ask you something, if it's okay.
Of course.
Like, the... Where'd that come from? Where the, you know, like the... the next of kin thing.
Yes.
I've put Dickie down, but, you know, because mm-hmm. he's getting old, so he'll probably die quite soon, I should imagine. Well, because he's old, you know. But I was just wondering if you'd like to be my next of kin.
Oh, I would love to.
Yeah. Oh, that's great.
Thank you.
I'll
of
add
course.
It. Could you tell me what your telegram number is? I know it, but I haven't got it written down. It's over at the telegram station.
IQ 879. IQ 879.
Yeah, right, I've got that. Thank you.
Perfect. Thank you. That means a lot, actually.
No, thanks. No, it's, you know, you mean a lot to me, so I wanted you to be like my next of kin. I mean, you know, anything happens to me in the line of duty, you'd probably be like the first to know about it anyway.
Yeah, thank you.
No problem. I think
I really care about you.
Yeah,
I
really care about you. You're not my sister.
And
I care about everybody.
I feel the same.
Yeah. Well, yeah. I'm your sister.
Well, I mean, maybe more like a little brother. But
yeah.
Yeah. Maybe like a little brother.
That's just my little joke.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, the Rangers is a lot of family, but, you know, you're very close, you know, because you've always been there and always been kind, and, you know, I just thought, well, you'd, like, be perfect if you didn't mind being my next of kin, so that's great.
Of course. Thank you.
Yeah, I do have a spot where I'd like my ashes scattered. It's only down the road, and perhaps when we get another time, I'll show you where it is. It's a really nice spot. It's like got a lovely view and everything.
Yeah.
Yeah, great.
I'll show you where I'd like to be as well.
Yeah. Yeah, God forbid anything happens to us, but it's nice to know these things, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. Yeah. It's important.
Yeah.
I'm gonna quickly go up and get a gun for my horse in case Hal needs it.
Right.
And
okay.
I'll be right back.
All right, no problem. Okay. Yeah.
All right.
You stay safe.
Are you both okay?
I'm just
bored. Oh. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I will get you some money in a moment. We'll get a crate. And you're going to have to put everything other than...
You're doing a trial. Is he doing a trial, is he?
He is doing a trial with Hal, if Hal wakes up.
I think I just saw Hal, but that might have been... what Wolf saw, because they got like very similar tops on.
I have a question.
Yeah.
Can I put you as my next of kin?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I'll be honoured.
Honestly, you're like a brother to me at this point, so I wanted to ask.
Yeah. No, that's great. I mean, I've got Dickie and I just asked Kat, actually, so...
I've got Kat too.
Yeah, well, I'll get you as well if that's all right.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. Then, God forbid, eh? What's your telegram number?
My telegram number is Northern Star 671, so NS671.
Let me give you a crate.
That's great. I'll remember that and I'll add that later.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm just waiting for Flo. She's coming. She's going to tell me all about Gorma.
What? I appreciate you.
I appreciate you too.
You're such a sweetheart.
Oh, and you too. Thank you.
No, I'm bright dawn. Sorry, I'm dark dusk today.
Nah, it won't last long. The black cloud will soon go.
Maybe.
Just remember what I said, you know, actions speak louder than words.
Yeah, that's true.
Yo, folk rangers.
Yeah.
Hello.
How can we help?
No, nothing major. Small little favor I'm asking.
Okay.
Figure the rangers see a lot of folk to come through here, and a lot of them might be better off than others. If you wouldn't mind passing off the word that I'm hiring for my company, that would be wonderful.
What is your company?
Williams Trade Co.
Okay.
They asked for a telegram. Company telegram is Indigo Whiskey 613. Tell them we hire for courier, security, secretaries, anybody that can write, read, edit paper.
Okay.
As well as gatherers and company cooks.
Let's go! I got places to be!
So kind
I will make a note of that, and I will also let people know if they are looking for jobs, I will send them your way.
I appreciate that.
Have you thought about putting like notices up in the telegram offices for your work?
I prefer newspaper ads, which I do. It's a little bit more professional, my
Yeah,
opinion.
Yeah.
Yes,
Valentine's probably a good place, you know. Whenever I've gone there, there's always been people talking about doing security work and stuff, so.
Oh, yeah. I like to reach every corner I can.
Yeah.
I figured this was probably the biggest one here in Starberry.
Yeah.
Yeah, let me move this for the film. But
hello, sir.
If you could help me out with this, that'd be greatly appreciated.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Well,
I'd like to help everybody
yeah.
out any way I can.
Yeah, of course.
I think it works the best way to do that.
I see.
I'll definitely see what I can do.
That's wonderful. Do y'all need anything here?
No, I think we're okay. But thank you for asking. Do you need anything at all?
No, I reckon I'm all right right now. Okay. Appreciate that, though.
Ain't no problem. We'll be here if you do. Okay.
I appreciate that. Thank you. You have a good day.
No problem. And you too. Take care. Hello, White Wolf. How you doing?
Hey, Rodney.
I hear you got a trial today. It's very exciting. Yeah.
Very exciting indeed. Honestly, you shouldn't. Okay, so one thing is, don't be nervous because you are amazing, for one. Secondly, you're very knowledgeable. Thirdly, you're going to absolutely ace this trial. Fourthly, you're with Hal.
Yeah.
You and Hal are going to work together really well.
Just make sure you eat and drink as much as you can. Before
I'm
you
getting
go.
That sorted now, what I need.
I love you, and I believe in you, and you've got this.
Cat, what should I do with, like, my binoculars, lantern, and lasso?
Okay, so...
Should I give those to somebody?
I have no problem
turned up, so I'll be going shortly.
Otherwise, I can take for me.
Because I have... water, I have coffee, a horse brush, and some food, and then obviously bandages and stuff. Do you want to check my pockets? Okay.
Yep, that's perfect. Alright, let's see.
That's all I have, plus the...
Flo! Flo! Hello? Hello, Flo!
Hello, how are you? Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. How are you?
Oh, well, good, thank you. I'm just going to tell Nandor to go to the stable because I think he's being a bit of a moody little horse today.
I'll get out of the way in case he goes and knocks me flying. Get behind this barrel. It's nice to see you back safe and sound in one piece.
Yeah, just about. It was quite dangerous.
Yeah, quite scary.
Have you seen Dickie?
No, he's, I think he's going to be like about, about an hour or so, maybe.
Oh, okay, I'll let him tell you all about what he got up to there.
Yeah, I'll send him another telegram. If you want to come over with me, or you can say hello to the Rangers.
Okay.
Is that Mac? Is that Mac there? It's not, is it? No, it's not his horse.
No, he has a real expensive horse now.
Yeah, the Turkoman, isn't it? He's got...
he changed it, I think. He went and got himself a Hungarian half-bred.
Blimey, yeah.
In red liver chestnut coat.
I think they're about $2,000, aren't they? Yeah, he did ever so well.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah.
I think he's very suited to that.
Yeah, definitely.
I mean, he's quite overprotective.
Yeah, he is, yeah. It's only me, Dom.
Gasp.
Not a ruffian.
You are the worst ruffian ever.
Yeah.
You're the biggest criminal of all.
Yeah, the worst. Most dastardly.
So, I was actually thinking... see, as I can't do it. You know when we want to, like, motion for somebody to become a ranger?
Yeah.
Do you think that White Wolf is ready?
Yeah, I do, yeah. On the patrols and the search and rescues he's come on, yeah, definitely.
So, you know how to do it, right?
What?
Like, through the paperwork. And, like, suggesting that he should be promoted. See, yeah. I would do it, but I'm his wife, so it would be...
No, you're still a ranger. You're still entitled to your vote.
I know, but it seemed biased.
No, do it. Put it down.
I'm going to do it after his trial, I think. I will see how his trial goes.
Yeah. I'll definitely put my vote down.
Okay. Wonderful. I hope you enjoy yourself.
Yeah, we'll do. Flo, this is... have you met Dawn, my friend?
Hi.
Hello.
She's a ranger.
Oh, hello.
Good to meet you.
Lovely to meet you too.
I sorry. I'm in a little bit of a rush because I've got a trial to go to as soon as Hal wakes up. But yeah. I hope you two have a wonderful day.
Yeah, thanks very much. I'll probably see you tomorrow.
Of course.
I'll be on duty tomorrow.
Okay.
Good luck.
Right, that's that sorted. Okay. Do you want a chocolate milk?
Oh, yes, please. Thank you.
Oh, banana. Oh, very nice.
A gift from Guarma.
Thanks very much. It's
I
lovely.
Would have got more, but I managed to lose a lot of it falling down the... I slept on a ledge.
Well, you have to tell me all about
tumbled
it.
Tumbled down the mountain.
Oh, blimey. Did you hurt yourself?
Yeah, I twisted my ankle real bad.
Oh, I wonder why you was hobbling a little bit.
Yeah. It's much better than it was, because I've been resting it, but...
Yeah.
It was real scary. I was laying there for hours. I thought I was going to die. I thought monkeys were going to eat
me. Where was Dickie?
Oh, Dickie had... I don't think Dickie had woken up at that point. I went looking for lemons.
Well, it's a bit silly. You should have waited for him. Because it's like a dangerous place and you both don't know it very well.
No.
Well, see, I should have come out there as well.
Ah, well.
But I didn't know you were going. And then
he told me he was wanting to go,
but no one told me you were going. And then when I woke up, I saw that you'd gone, and I was like, what?
Dickie said he told you.
And I was quite upset about it.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I thought Dickie had told you.
I thought we're all friends and we stick together no matter what. Like the boat trip, even though I was absolutely terrified, I still did it because we're all friends.
Yeah.
But don't
we did a diving contest. It was scary.
The what?
A diving contest over
God.
In Warmer.
No, I'm not doing that.
Mm. Oh, we did it.
You did it?
Yeah.
It's very dangerous. There's no rangers there to help people.
Oh, they had a nice doctor there, though. Her name was Vivian.
Oh, I think I know her.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I don't know her, but I've met her a couple of times.
Yeah, she had the voice of an angel.
Yeah, it's very nice. Is that the one that Dickie likes?
Oh, I don't know. He said he telegrammed her, but yet again, one of the many people that Dickie has telegrammed who never responded to him.
Yeah, it's like a sort of ongoing thing, isn't it, really? Going round and round.
Yeah.
Anyway, come on. Let's go to the camp. And we'll sit up on the nice rock bit. I told Dickie that's where we're going to be. When he wakes up, he can just get there, can't he?
How are you, mister?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Yes, I've had some thing in the rangers.
Honestly, it's so busy. I'm sorry I didn't get to speak to you when I saw you the other day.
No problem.
Hang on a minute. Good luck.
Don't lose anything.
Thank you.
You'll be fine. See you soon.
All right, have a good day.
And you too, take care. Good luck.
Oh, if you want.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah, he's off to do his trial.
Oh.
Yeah.
How long does the trial take?
A couple of hours.
Oh. And how long after being a ranger recruit do you have to do your trial?
Well, you can do one straight away. I mean, I signed up and started, my first day I did a snow patrol, which is it's not like just going for a gallop around roads. It's quite a dangerous thing.
Quite dangerous.
Yeah. And then when I finished that, Deuce said to me, do you fancy doing a trial next week? And I thought, you're having a laugh, ain't you? I've only just become a ranger. Well, a recruit ranger. And you can do them straight away, basically.
Oh, how long did you wait? Did you do it the next week?
Yeah, I did, yeah. Oh. Yeah, yeah. But luckily I did it with this nice lady called Allegra, who had been a recruit for quite a while, and she kind of knew where things were. So, she carried me, really.
Mm. Sounds like you can do it alone or with someone else.
Yeah, you can do it. You can pick whoever you want to go, and whoever wants to go with you, you can do it that way. You know, I mean,
that's nice.
Yeah, I mean,
can it be another proper ranger? Or?
Yeah, you can have a proper ranger. So,
oh, that's
like,
good.
You know, Matt could do it with me if he wanted.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's good.
I'll just tie a moonshadow out of this tree. Yeah, it's a nice little spot up here. Can you get up all right? It's a bit steep.
Well, after all that climbing and warmer.
This is nothing, isn't it? I bet.
Yeah. Oh, there was like a hotel at the top of the mountain. It took so long to climb up. There were so many ladders. And
really?
Oh, it was terrifying.
Bit of a slide there. I thought it'd be nice to sit on the grass.
Yeah.
This is where I had my secret ranger meeting.
Ah.
Well, yeah, I think, where was it? Yeah, no, it was here, I think. Yeah, it was, yeah.
Wonderful view.
Yeah, it's nice. Let's sit down here.
Does Sir Dickie know we'll be here?
Well, I told him we'd be at the camp and he'll see Moonshadow, so he'll know I'm up here. But yeah, got a nice view. That's where I got my mother's cross, just up there. And I just had to do my next of kin form. And I told them, you know, that I'll have to show them, you know, where I want my ashes scattered. Because I just thought it's been a nice spot, really. Because you've got the mountains behind, but you know, you can't see them from here because that big boulder's in the way. I don't think there's any wolves on this side, but if there are, we've got a couple of rocks we can just quickly get up on.
Okay. Alright. Hang on, my ankle's hurting a bit, so I'll just get down very slow, like.
That's alright. I did notice you was like, had a bit of a limp. I thought perhaps you had a stone in your boot or something.
Oh no, it's still quite swollen, you see. But luckily, one of the locals found me. He was a citizen of Guarma, but he was, right. You know, he lives there all the time now.
Right.
He said he's sometimes in Saint-Denis. His name was Morgan.
Morgan. I think I've heard the name Morgan, but, you know, I'm not sure if I've met him. But, yeah, I mean, I was obviously worried about, you know, going over there with that Edgar. So, you know, I would have been quite scared at first, but I didn't really want to be like... Yeah, he's like the king there, apparently. He like apparently owns the whole island. He was the one that like bashed my head in. Would you like me to help you sit down?
Yes, please, because I've been sitting on chairs.
Okay.
It's a bit difficult to sit on the ground.
All right, just give me a sec. Bear with me, I'm still thinking. Don't worry.
Oh, I found it. That's it. Oh, I'm sliding down.
Oh, there you go.
Am I sliding down? No.
No.
I was sliding down the mountain on my ass.
Yeah, that's fair. I've just got to do the vote thing. I've just got to write it down on a bit of paper.
What's the vote thing?
So White Wolf can get like it's basically you know when we think a ranger's ready, we all do a lot of vote to say whether he's ready or not, and if he gets enough votes, then he gets passed.
Oh, that's good. And how many rangers have to vote?
As many as possible, I think.
Wonder if there is a minimum. so pretty. So quiet up here.
Yeah. Hang on a minute. I'm still thinking about things. Hang on.
That's okay. You must sleep ever so well here with it all being so quiet.
Yeah.
Oh, is that cougar corner over there?
That's all. I'll talk this out later. You what? What a cougar? Where?
Is that it? No, I can't see one, but I think that's the area where I was told there was always a cougar.
Yeah, the ranch opposite. That's like the cougar. So you've got like the entrance, the gate things. He's normally around there where there's tents, and he can be along the fence line from there all the way up to like the crest of the hill. You see like where the road is like a little kink bit where it ramps up and then goes flat.
Oh.
He can be there where those trees are on the top. So
dear.
If you're ever that way, just be careful.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so, Matt, he did ever so well, you know, he was pretty nervous and that, and he came over and there was me there and Hal, and, you know, Hal said, well, we'll take you on a patrol. He'd never done a patrol before, so he did a patrol round Big Valley, and there was like a bear there, and we had to kill the bear, and then there was another bear, and we had to kill the bear. He did ever so well. You know, he's really nice and that. So everyone likes him. Well, everyone's nice in the Rangers.
Yeah, he works very hard.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know, he grew up on a farm, so he's used to putting the hours in. And it's good because he'll be able to do the early shifts.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think he'll do well. He's, you know, he's fitted in really good so far, and I think he'll pick it up. You know, I showed him how to do a wellness check, you know, the thing where you go to the house and say, you know, Saints Crossing Ranger Corps, here, do a wellness check, and we went into the mines, you know.
Why do you have to do wellness checks then, if you've heard like if someone's reported something, or is it just a random thing?
Well, it's like you just want to, you know, if you're going on a search, like in an area, and there is a house there, someone might have like crawled inside there that's been injured. So you just have to like go in to make sure there's anybody in there. You know, someone might have picked them up, you see, and taken them in.
Oh, I see.
So we just got to like, you know, make sure that there's no one about in there. So, you know, I showed him how to do that. He done all right, and you know, he seemed to be really pleased, and you know, seemed to fit in really well. So I don't think he'd have any trouble, you know, as long as he, you know, don't do anything silly.
Yeah, he's very good with a gun as well, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
He's been getting those making the big baits. Attracting cougars and panthers.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, if he knows the crossing really well, then, like I've said it before, he's halfway there. So, you know, if he knows places, then I think
he knows
fine.
The danger areas, but I don't know that he knows the names of places yet.
Yeah, that's the thing. You know, I was going to say, if he just goes on solo patrols and stuff like that, he can do that. But if he knows the areas, then I think he'll be fine. He's just got to... You know, just go through the motions, get a trial done.
Yeah, just experience. And, yeah. What did you have to do on your trial?
I had to go out to a New Austin out in the desert.
Oh.
And we had to find three areas because they were like marked with like a colour. So we had to identify the areas and what colour they were. We had to find like three different herbs. In different locations, obviously.
Yeah.
And then we had to go and find different animals and get their skin so that we could then sort of show that we found them. And like fish, we had to get some fish as well.
Yeah. How's your fishing guard going?
I haven't really done much to it because, like, I haven't really seen you, and I've been so busy doing ranger stuff. Yeah, I mean, like that day I saw you, I was on my own. I had like a sheriff talking to me about like a search and rescue. I could like hear across the bridge the alarm going in the ranger station.
Oh,
and
no.
Then I had some strange fella. Well, I think it was a fella, looked like a lady with a bald head. And they were like talking to me, and then they came over, and I was like trying to write out the tip, and they were talking through the door, and I was thinking like what's going on, and all the while I was thinking I didn't even like I saw you, and I didn't even get a chance to say hello.
Oh, it's okay. I could see that you were real busy.
Yeah, I was a bit like flummoxed because I was on my own. I was trying to do it all, and there was no one around.
Overwhelming.
Yeah, I was a bit under pressure, but I've just been been really busy, but I've like got to grips now with the paperwork.
That's good.
Yeah, I mean, some of the things.
Here's the battle.
Well, exactly. I mean, if they say, "Oh, can you do one of these reports?" I think, "Well, how the bloody hell do I do that? I've never done one before." But they, you know, they're happy to show me.
That's good.
So yeah, I've just been doing lots of search and rescues, just doing range of things.
You rescuing a lot of people. Where have people been there?
Well, it's been so much stuff out in New Hanover, sort of like around Valentine, that sort of way.
Yeah.
But that's like, strange. Just never finding them. So.
Oh yeah.
Honestly,
it's a
like.
Big open area.
Yeah, yeah. I'd say probably 9 out of 10 times just don't find them. It's like 1 in 10 that you find someone because people don't wait about. They just.
No.
Give up. They think, well, no one's going to find me. If they've been laying there for half an hour, I just think, no, just wait. We will find you, and then you won't get like some local come up to you and say, I'll help you, and robs you blind when you're all like limp and you can't do anything.
Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah. But apart from that, I've just been, you know, just doing my range of things really. Not had a chance to do any fishing or anything, so.
Oh, I caught a rainbow trout at Flatiron Lake.
Oh.
It wasn't worth as much as I thought it would be, though. It looked real pretty. And I thought it would be like a rock bass or something, because it's quite big.
Yeah, oh
yeah. But I only got about $7 or $8 for it.
That's not bad. That's above the average.
Oh.
I mean, you know, an average sort of fish that you get, like a bluegill or something like that, it's only $5.
Yeah, I've been throwing a lot of the bluegills back in the water.
Well, I don't. I keep them because...
I keep them if they're over 3 kilos.
I still keep them regardless because you're still going to get, like, $4 or $5. And that's, you know, $4 or $5 you're just throwing away. A couple of those, that's, like, $8, isn't it?
Yes, but quite often I've been getting pickerel into, you know, bass. So, and I get more for them. Apart from some of the bass are real big and you end up really weighed down with them all because they're quite heavy.
But where'd you go fishing then? Because honestly, when I used to fish at my spot in Rhodes, I didn't mind getting the smaller fish that didn't cost a lot because... I was like backwards and forwards so quick, it didn't matter.
Oh, yeah, I guess so. Well, I was going to just from there, actually. There's a pier, and I was riding along to the usual spot on the beach, and there's a road towards the pier from
I've been there with
from the west. Yeah, I could see loads of fish in the water, and I thought, I'm going to try here, and I did, and it was real lucrative.
Right. Yeah. Well, I mean, you know...
I made $100.
That's really good. That is really good. Yeah, because, you know, I know it's a lot of, like, pocket space, ain't it? And you obviously want the more expensive...
Yeah, and I
had my crate. Oh, right. So you could really fill up then, couldn't you?
Yeah.
Oh, that's perfect, yeah. I mean, it's just... It's not worth it when you're, like, trying to fish somewhere and you've got a long trek to go.
Oh,
so, you know, go and sell them.
To the butchers
then
and the bank.
Yeah. It's like strawberry's not very like productive like that. Okay, it's got a butcher's, but you still got a fair way to travel to the lakes, and then there's no bank, so you then got to go to Blackwater, you know.
Yeah, or Valentine is very risky.
Yeah, exactly. And you've only got to bump in the wrong person, and you're just like, and you got a load of money on you, just he'll have that. No questions.
Exactly.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's why I quite like that spot in Blackwater, you know, the one we found.
Because that's good.
Yeah, that's not far from the butchers and in the banks, only around the corner.
Yeah, that was real handy.
Yeah.
But have you found that when you go fishing with another person, one of you just doesn't get anything?
Yeah, yeah.
I think fish get confused by two lots of bait.
Yeah. Yeah, me and Dickie found that whenever we fish together, we struggle. But, you know, if we're on our own doing it, it's not a problem. So it's probably one of those things it's best to do on your own. You know, if you're sort
which
of doing
is a
it,
shame.
yeah. But you know, if you're seriously trying to just get like money, then solo fishing is the way. Because that's what I did in Rhodes. I just needed like loads of money to get like a rifle, and I just did it for hours on end, fish, there and back. I mean, it was pretty boring, but after a while, when you see your bank balance getting up past $500, you think, well, this ain't bad, you know.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've been supplementing my income with the fishing.
Yeah.
You taught me very well.
That's all right. Happy to help, really. So how much have you got in the bank then? Have you got quite a lot?
$800.
That's not bad. It's not bad. Do you want
to
know?
And that's after guarma.
Right, yeah. I mean, that's quite expensive, ain't it?
Yeah, $300.
Yeah. I've got like 4,000 in my bank.
Oh my goodness me.
Yeah.
And it's a hell of a lot of money.
Yeah, you think I bought a bolt action, a Lancaster, a Navy, and a $1,000 horse as well.
Oh my.
You know, and I still got 4,000 in the bank, so.
Goodness me, that was all from fishing and rangering?
Pretty much, yeah. I mean, before I started rangering, I think I had about 3,500 in the bank. After buying my horse and the guns, yeah.
Oh,
so
that's amazing.
Yeah, yeah.
I wonder how much Sir Dickie has.
Not a lot. He's always skint. I had to buy him two Schofields, didn't I?
Oh.
Because he's always losing his, because he's like a bit careless. So, you know, I didn't like to think of him wandering around aimlessly, lost in the wilds without a gun. So I took pity on him because he's like quite old. And bought him a gun, and then he lost it, and then I had to go and buy him another one.
Oh, dear. He's surprisingly agile for a man his age.
Yeah, he's quite sprightly on his feet.
I thought if I wasn't found by that Morgan in Guarma, and if the locals robbed me, I'd have had to have stayed there for 3 weeks earning enough money to come back.
Oh, no, that's the worrying thing. It's like you get trapped there.
Yeah.
You gotta like, I don't know, pick bananas or something to make money.
And it's real hard because I don't need anything that ever had a face, you know.
Yeah.
I don't have much food there that isn't me.
Right.
I think I overdosed on bananas.
Yeah, well it's like
you'd get a real bad tummy, you would.
Yeah, well I've got a bit of trouble. So having a lot of fruit would just play havoc with it. I would be like, you know, shitting all over the place, part of my potty mouth.
I'd be like, and your potty ass.
Yeah. Yeah. Just be like, my ring would be on fire.
Oh, no.
I'd have to look for, like, aloe vera to rub on it.
Yeah, going back onto some cactus.
Yeah.
Right here, that was circling, isn't it? I think the aloe vera. They don't have the spikes, do they?
No.
That would be another world altogether.
Yeah, I would like to rub a bit of cactus around my anus.
Burning ring, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Adding insult to injury.
Oh, it would, yeah. Mm. Is that gunfire?
Yeah, it is.
Let's go and have a look. I don't know where that's coming from. I reckon that's wolves. Can you see anything, Flo?
Yeah?
It sounded like it was like coming over from that direction there. Over there.
Oh, wow. Oh.
But normally the wolves are over that way.
Hmm. How odd. I saw lots of a deer running this way. Hmm.
That could be ruffians. So what happens, sometimes people try and run away from the wolves and the wolves chase them. And they could have been chased from, from like over, you know, over that way, over there, to like over here.
That's right.
Let's jump on Moonshadow, let's go and have a look. It might even be Dickie. Can ride down the road here and have a look up the road.
Yeah. It's a good thing you're a ranger.
Yeah. I can't see any wolf bodies.
No. Yeah, I mean, at least the same wolves that turn, you know, sometimes run to your camp.
Yeah, normally they'd be around that like little clump of trees there to our right. As you sort of go in past the trees.
Oh,
that
yeah,
ring.
I can see something. Oh, there's a wagon.
Let's have a look up here.
Yeah, maybe someone tried to run onto a rock or something.
Yeah. But I can't see any wolf bodies.
No.
Which makes me wonder where it was. It did sound close.
Yeah. I wonder if we get someone to call out, maybe if they're down.
Well, yeah, if they're down, I'll be able to help them.
Oh, there's that mint.
Do you want to get a bit? Yeah. Quick, grab a bit. Do you want me to grab it as well?
Oh, yes, please, because it's quite rare.
Was there two along here?
Real hard to see.
Yeah, so there's one here, and there's another one as well, weren't there?
And a third one?
No, there's two. I didn't see where the other one, the first one you got.
Oh, I thought you did.
I just got that one just there. Oh, I see it. You're right there. Yeah, I think there's only two bits here, aren't there? Which is a bit...
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
Yeah, I haven't worked out what it does
yet. Did we look over there, did we, on that cliff? I think we did, didn't we? We'll have a quick look.
Actually, I'm sure we did. Or I might have looked over there with Mac. Oh, sorry.
It's all right. Have you got dicky fingers?
No.
Try not to drop it. Got it?
Dicky fingers.
Sticky fingers. He's terrible. Everything he touches,
I
then can't pick up.
Well, do you know why I think that is?
Why?
Someone bring guarma.
Yeah.
That We saw that man that Dickie likes, Taron Ledger.
I don't think I know him.
Oh, okay. Well, Dickie likes him. And he was in the diving contest. And he was oiled up in whale blubber.
Oh.
Now, I wonder if Dickie had done that.
Yeah, he'd be ever so sticky. See, I thought it might be cement along here.
Yeah, can't see any.
It's too foggy to even see light.
It is. Yeah.
I don't want to put us at danger.
No, I have learned my lesson about that now.
Yeah.
I'm going to be much more careful in future.
No, that's a bit dangerous going
that
way.
Also, it's quite embarrassing because every time I need to get rescued by a ranger, it's Alfred that has to rescue me.
Oh, right.
Poor Alfred.
I was
he
out
must
on
be
a...
sick of the sight of me.
No, he's all right. I was on a search and rescue with him yesterday.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah. Well, I wonder where these wolves were. It's the thing with bat guns, is like, you know, the shots are sort of like quite echoey, so it's hard to tell exactly
never know where
they...
it's coming from.
No. Sounds like there's a bear.
Yeah. Scary.
I think
is there
just
like
be...
a black bear? Oh, look, there's a horse at the camp. Oh, they're wild horses.
Yeah. I've never seen one. So, there's no horse at the camp, is there? So he's not there.
Not yet. Now, there was a black horse there, but I think it's a wild horse.
Yeah.
And I think it's... Oh, look at that horse having a little roll around.
Yeah, it's nice. It's one having a little sleep.
Yeah.
Right. It's raining now. Do you want to go out of the camp and get a bit of shelter?
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully Dickie will be here soon.
Yeah.
And then,
I can't wait for him to tell you all about him and Guam.
Oh, yeah, I want to hear more of your stories.
Well.
So, did you say there was monkeys as well in your telegram?
Well, I heard there were, but I never saw any.
Oh, right. They'd probably be eating all the bananas. See if I can sit down under here.
Yeah, it's real hard. It's not very spacey.
This one over here is probably better. Look, now this is perfect. I know it's a little bit like wet underneath, but there's no water's going to get on our heads here. Then we can just sit down here, can't we?
We got there on the boat. The boat was real nice. We went with that Arthur King. And when we got there, there was a scavenger hunt to do where we had to find certain items.
Oh, so they do like and different activities and things.
Yeah, it was a festival.
Oh, right.
Yeah, there were quite a few people. And I think there was like a proper hunt, but I didn't stay for that because I was tired from the journey.
Right.
Oh, but on a scavenger hunt, we went up to this like area on like near the top of the cliffs.
Right.
And Sir Dickie.
Yeah.
He accidentally slipped off the diving platform because he slipped.
Did he?
He hit his head on the way down and made an almighty thud.
God.
Just the most almighty thud down the rocks, and oh, it was terrifying. And I went down to try and rescue him. And I slipped on the rock myself and into the water and got washed up on the shore.
Oh, no.
And, and then Arthur had to rescue me. And there was another man that had to, I think it might have been Taron himself. No, it wasn't. There was another man anyway.
Right.
Who, he had to be rescued too. So this poor lady that was with us, Amelia.
Right.
Aurelia or something like that.
Aurelia.
Yeah, that's the one.
I keep thinking her name's Octavia, but it's a, it is Aradia.
Yeah, Aradia. She was real nice.
Oh.
She ran off and got some medical bags and helped us with our injuries.
Oh, that's good. So there was a lot of nice people over there, because I heard that it's just like a hive of scum and villainy.
Oh, no, not at all. Everyone we saw was lovely. Oh. I think they got rid of all the villains.
Oh. Oh, that's even better. Then I'm even happier to go over there.
Yeah.
I know Alfred's trying to get like, he's doing a project where it's going to be like groups of four of us going over at a time.
Oh, that would be real useful.
Yeah, and perhaps we could.
Because I was lying there for hours.
Yeah, I think it's just like a research thing. I don't think we're going to be permanently there. But that's what they need. They need like...
Oh, definitely. They need researchers there anyway.
Yeah.
Right. A lot to learn. I was walking around on one of the mountains in the forest, and I came to this camp, and there was a man who looked like he'd been drenched in melted chocolate.
Oh.
He looked real glistening, but I think it might have been tar.
Right.
He was stuck to a pole in a tent. It was scary.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Was he alive?
No.
Oh, God.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was horrible.
Yeah, that would have frightened me very much. Mm-hmm. I would have had nightmares, that's for sure.
Yeah, I think that's what made me go running off and made me slip down the ledge.
Yeah, well, I probably would have done the same. Seeing a man tied at a stake, all looking like chocolate.
Yeah.
And I love chocolate.
Mm-hmm.
Like chocolate milk.
Yeah, it was like dark chocolate as well. It was real oily looking.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Like a sort of greasy black pudding.
Yeah, it was horrible when you couldn't see his eyes or nothing.
Oh, are they taking his eyes out?
No, I think, like, it just burned his eyes.
Oh, God. Oh, yeah, that would terrify me.
And he was kneeling as well.
He was what?
Kneeling down against his post.
Oh.
He had to.
Must have been quite uncomfortable.
Yeah, must have, I mean, probably really hurt his knees before he got drowned in chocolate.
Yeah. Oh, God. I suppose that place is, like, beautiful, but at the same time, completely terrifying.
Yeah, that's exactly what it was like.
So is it very tropical?
Very. It was real hot, and you had to be real careful about where you put your feet because the snakes would bite you. And I lost a pair of boots. I had to buy new boots while I was out there.
Oh, no.
Yeah, they were second-hand ones.
Yeah.
I got some new ones as soon as I got back here because, they were quite tatty.
Right. Were they a little bit too tight or something?
Yeah, especially with my swollen ankle. But, what else happened? So that was the first day.
Oh, my God, first day?
Yeah. And I went up to bed.
Yeah.
And then the second day was when I was, we had the diving contest and we watched some fighting. But Dickie went to bed after the diving because he'd put a huge effort into it and was real tired.
Yeah, well, he's old, isn't he?
Yeah. And I think seeing Taryn all greased up was a little bit too much for him. I think he had to go and have some private time.
Yeah, probably went and had a bit of a cry.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
Because Terry was there with his new girlfriend.
Oh.
And Aurelia was upset because Aurelia used to go out with Terry too, apparently.
Oh, blimey. So it's like sort of some sort of love triangle.
Yeah.
Oh, so Dickie liked the fella, did he?
Yeah.
I thought he was a bit funny. I think he might like men and women.
Oh, yeah. Probably.
Yeah. He's never tried anything with me.
Oh, that gives him more options then, I guess.
Yeah, yeah.
He needs to widen the pool as much as possible, at his age.
Yeah, I was going to say, at his age, he's, I suppose he just hungers for where it's at.
Mm-hmm.
He's probably not fussy at all, is he?
Oh, well, I hope not.
I suppose, you know.
Otherwise, he's going to be a very lonely man.
Well, yeah. I suppose if they're quite nice looking, that's like a big bonus for him.
Mm-hmm.
But he does get his heart set on things, don't he? Like,
he does.
What's her name?
Bessinger. Rose Bessinger.
No. It's one that he was always going on about. It might have been Vivian. Which one might have been Vivian? I mean, honestly, there's so many. There was like Dawn, there was Cassie.
Oh.
You know, there's all these ladies that come into his life that he's, you know, gets his heart stuck on. And he just, gets himself like completely absorbed by him. And then, gets a bit like obsessive.
Oh, he's such a dramatic man.
Yeah. See, I've never had a girlfriend. You know, there was, a nice lady that I used to fancy when I lived in Colchester. Mother owned a florist. And when I used to work in the market, because, my mother only let me out of the house when I was, like, 18, because then she thought I was, grown up enough to, like, go out into the big wild world.
That was only last year.
Yeah. I mean, I basically just had, like, the run of the house and the back garden. So I didn't really see much of the world. Yeah, sometimes she'd let me go out in the fields, because there's a lot of fields, and I'd go and, look at caterpillars and things like that. But, actually meeting people, she was worried about me, especially when I went to school, the bigger boys, picked on me. So she took me out of school.
Dear.
Yeah. I was asked to work in the market, just like, scooping up the whole shit, pardon my potty mouth, and loading wagons and things like that. And there was this like really nice lady. She was like, I don't know, probably not the same age as me. And she was lovely. And her name was Emily. Emily Lovebucket.
Lovebucket?
Yeah.
That's a very interesting surname.
Yeah, it's lovely, ain't it?
Mm.
Yeah. But she was ever so pretty. And I wanted to sort of like go and talk to her and, ask her out for a picnic. But, Every time I'd like walk in the shop, I'd just feel like I needed to go and have a tinkle, so I never got to talk to her, unfortunately. And then I come to the crossing, so,
And now you talk to what kinds of people?
Yeah, lots of people like me, which is nice, considering, I've never really been sociable with people.
No. Yeah, it's very good.
Yeah. All the rangers really like me.
Oh, yeah. I think Alfred said you were one of his favourites.
Yeah, I like Alfred, yeah. Yeah, he's really nice. I mean, that's the thing about the Rangers, that they are really, really nice, and you can trust them with your life. Like, you got their back as much as they got your back, and that's what I like. Because, after my experience with those bandits, the ruffians, I just thought, well, I don't really want to be on my own.
No.
And I wanted to be a ranger. And I just thought, well, being in the Rangers is perfect then, because I'll always have people around me to protect me and
that's
protect
right.
them. Yeah.
Oh, I see. You have like a ready-made family.
Yeah. Yeah, but I do miss my mother, Because... I don't know if I told you, but, my father, he murdered my mother.
Oh, my God, that's horrendous.
Yeah, and...
sorry to hear that.
He tried to murder me, and that's why I had to leave.
Oh, my God.
But I'll tell you about another time. That looks like that's Dickie.
Oh, yeah, that's Dickie.
Dickie!
Hello.
Hey, Dickie.
Hello, Dickie.
Hello.
How are you?
Oh, yes. Most marvellous, in fact. Yes.
It's lovely to see you. Yes.
All right, put me down, old boy.
I let go. Sorry.
Has Flo been talking to you about our little vacation?
Yeah.
Oh, but I didn't tell him about your, your... how should we say it? Your...
whisper.
The contest.
Oh, yes. Did he know it took place? Did he know that we competed?
No.
Can I come back yet?
Yes, of course. I got got a couple of souvenirs for you, old boy.
Oh, lovely.
But nothing exciting because well, the main exports are cigars and rum. And you don't smoke and don't drink, so I don't know what you do, old boy. But
I'll give him a banana.
Oh, yes. Yeah, the banana's perfect.
Oh, yes. You do drink coffee, though, don't you, old boy?
Yeah, I do, yeah.
Lovely. I brewed this on the island and carried it back without spilling any.
Oh.
And also, this is for Moonshadow. It's a Gwemeel the sugar.
Oh. Oh, he's spoiling him.
Yes.
It's chocolate milk.
Lovely. Oh, that'll do me lovely. Oh, thank you, old boy.
Thank you.
Yes.
Oh, I'll have the coffee now.
Yes, it's Gwemeel.
Oh, very nice quality.
Oh, yes. And
ooh,
it,
that's nice.
Oh, yes, it's a bit nutty, isn't it? A bit more nutty than the stuff
you
get.
Yeah, yeah, it's nice, yeah.
Yes, well, imagine me, we were crossing the sea, you know, rough seas, and there's me holding a cup of coffee, making sure I don't spill it anywhere.
That must have been quite tricky.
Yes, indeed. Well, what did Flo tell you about Guamar?
Well, basically, it seems to be a completely hostile, terrifying place, but yet, at the same time, like paradise.
Oh, yes.
You know, you both, like, had nasty falls.
Oh, yes. Well, I got a case of the... What did you call it, Flo? Vertigo?
Vertigo.
Yes.
Oh, God.
So, who was it that went off the first time? Was it...
I can't remember. Oh, there was Arthur, and there was another man, but I can't remember who the other
Maxwell.
Man was.
Yeah, so Flo and I and Arthur, we sort of went together on the boat and we bumped into Maxwell while we were there. And do you remember Aurelia?
Octavia.
No, that's her. She lives there now, you see.
Oh.
And she took us up the cliff tops, you know, she took us on a bit of a
nice.
Tour. And Arthur fell off this, well, he dived off this platform, which was...
Oh, blimey.
I would probably say, you know, this tree here is probably about as high as that tree into the water.
Wow, that is very high.
Yes. And
that's a good 30 foot at least.
Yeah. Oh, yes. And then I went over to look down to make sure he was okay. And I don't know what happened, old boy, but I came over a little queer.
Oh.
And next thing I know, I'm falling into the water.
Oh, God, that sounds harrowing.
But I bounced off of a rock, you see, and Flo came to rescue me, and she picked me up, and next thing I know, she's off the bloody edge as well.
Oh, God.
It was a real force.
Yes. And then Maxwell came to save us both, and next thing you know, he's on the bloody floor. Aurelia had to rescue us all.
See, there's no rangers on the island. It is an island, isn't it? Island of Gorma.
Yes.
Yeah, there's no rangers there, so you need rangers to help people like you that, you know, have a bit of a tumble when you feel a bit queer.
And that's exactly the reason why you should be coming out next time.
Well, I was going to come out there. I was saying to Flo, I was waiting for you to let me, you know, let me know, and then I would have come with you. I got is when I woke up, I looked at the telegrams and you'd gone.
Yes, trouble is.
And I was only asleep over there.
Yes. Well,
But next time we've got to go together, because I was saying to Flo, we are all friends, aren't we? We're all friends, and we have to stick together because you both got hurt, and that's no good because I'm a ranger and I'm there to help you.
All right, old boy, cool it is.
Calm down.
Sorry, it's the coffee.
Okay.
It's maybe a bit of flat. Yeah.
Oh, dear.
Sit yourself down. Oh, dear.
Yes.
Oh, my God.
You okay, old boy?
Oh, it's a caffeine rush. I've got a bit wibbly wobbly dicky.
Oh, yes, bit wibbly wobbly.
Right.
Yeah.
Just take
I'll just rest here for a little bit.
Focus on your breathing.
Yeah.
You okay, old boy?
Yeah. Oh,
come
that's
on,
better. Sorry, I've got a bit like, you know, all hyperactive or whatever it is.
Yeah. Well,
strong stuff at Guarma Coffee.
Yeah, I know.
Yes. Well, the good thing is, old boy, I think you should definitely come next time. Feel like we explored the whole island.
No, we did not.
Is it? I don't think there's any horses there, is there?
No, you do have donkeys, and they were real stupid.
Oh, God.
Oh, yes. Oh, but everything's in walking distance, old boy. It's not a big island, but there's lots of cliffs, you see. And I saw this wooden structure going all the way to the top of this cliff, and I thought, oh, I must go. But then the boat was leaving, and it all got a bit too much for me.
Next time I want to come. I mean, I wanted to come this time. I mean, obviously I was a bit frightened about Edgar, you know.
We heard nothing about Edgar or any of those militia there, did we?
Yeah, but I didn't realise it was a festival, so there would have been a lot more nice people than you know, because I have heard it's like a hive for scum and villainy.
No, I was speaking to Aurelia, and she said that's sort of a bit of a reputation that the Guamis have got, but it's all wrong. In fact, there's not many people living out there, old boy. It's a perfect holiday destination.
Oh, well, they need to improve their holiday brochures, don't they?
Aurelia was writing one.
Right.
Yes. Mm. Oh, that reminds me. Yeah. I got approached by Aurelia to go into the biography, the project that she's doing. Writing biographies of, famous and infamous people. And, she approached our digging.
Oh, right.
Is she a legendary actor?
Oh, yeah. I mean, you know, it's going to be an absolutely, you know, rip-roaring biography, ain't it?
Mm. Yes. She sent me a couple of questions on the old telegram.
Yeah.
And then we will discuss them. She will write it up into her book.
Wonderful. Sorry, go on. Carry on.
And I was going to say, when I'm dead, people will still be able to experience the Dickie.
Well, yeah, they'd all still want to have a bit of Dickie, won't they? You know, when you passed away. Hopefully, it's not going to be for a very, very long time.
No.
Given how agile you were on the second night.
The second day, old boy. It was an impromptu diving competition.
Oh.
And, this old bastard won it, old boy.
Really?
Yeah, he did. I was so proud.
Wow.
They judged you on flamboyancy, length, girth. Oh, no, that's something else.
Splash,
that was it.
Mm. Right.
How far you could, you know, shoot.
Did you have a swimming costume?
No, we just wore our clothes.
Right.
Well, I took a bit of a vacation outfit, you know, from... Yeah. The old summer, Dickie.
I'd like to see that.
Oh, yes. It was very coordinated, wasn't it, Flo?
Mm, yeah, he looked fabulous.
Oh, that's very nice.
Quite the part.
Yeah. Oh, glad to see you both. I've missed you so much, you two.
I have also, in a similar vein, missed you.
Yeah, that's nice.
Mm.
I've just been so busy doing Ranger stuff. Like non-stop, like pressure.
Night off, is it?
Yeah. Well, you know, because I know you're coming back, so I wanted to see you both.
Oh, lovely.
But that's great that you won the diving competition. So what did you win then? What was your prize?
I won $50.
Oh.
And a deck of cards from Guama.
Oh, right. Well, that'd be good for when we eventually get to do some poker.
Yes. Well, I've been here bloody 6 months now, not had one single bloody... Oh, no, I had one game that time, didn't I?
Yeah.
You were with me.
Yeah, the strange...
Last time I played.
Strange man.
They have poker on Guarma.
Yes.
We didn't go there, though, did we?
No.
So is there any, like, criminals and ruffians that are on the island, then?
Well, I don't... There may well be, old boy, but everyone was very inclusive and welcoming and...
Yeah.
You know, we stepped off the boat and there was a welcome party there. A chap called Julius Bradshaw.
Oh, he was nice.
Oh, yes. Beautiful man he was. Mm-hmm. Oh, yes.
Oh.
And, sorry, what? What are we doing? Yes, he met us off the boat.
Yeah.
Him and Aurelia and a couple of others.
Yeah.
Gave us the tour.
Yeah.
Told us about the events. Gave us a little book. Oh, it was Yes, welcoming very much so.
Oh, that's nice. That's nice. Yeah, no, I wish I'd come, you know. Yeah. But then I suppose, you know, I'm a ranger and I do have to do, like, my job, don't I? So, yeah. You know, I'll
just... Also, you need to make sure that, you know, you had food for your dodgy belly.
Yeah, I'd have to, like, just take a copious amounts of, like, steak with me so that, you know...
Well, you can. I think you could hunt out there, but, I mean, people were hunting.
Yeah.
There.
But they'd probably be eating things like lizards and monkeys.
Oh, I saw a lot of lizards.
Yes, I tried one of the lizards there.
Oh,
it was absolutely disgusting.
Was it very chewy?
Yes, like a fatty piece of meat, you know. With... Yes.
Quite stringy.
Scales stuck in your teeth.
Oh, yes. But they do have lots of wild boars, and they said to us, you know, the boar... Well, they're a bit like a pest, really. So if you want to hunt them, you can, and cook them up, spit roast them. They come up lovely.
You can't beat a nice bit of crackling, even with the hair indeed. On it.
Oh, yes. Well, the hair brushes your teeth. Oh, sorry, it's got a face, hasn't it?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, did you have a spit roast out there, Dickie?
Did you have a spit roast?
It was one morning I woke up, and they were preparing it, and I joined in.
Oh, good.
Oh, that's nice.
Yes, lovely. Lovely bit of pork in the morning.
Yeah.
How delightful.
Well, next time I'll have to, like, make sure I inform the rangers that I'm going to have, like, a small holiday. You know, like, a long weekend or something, like, go on a Friday. Come back on, like, I don't know, like, a Monday even. Have a real long weekend.
Yes, I think... Yes, probably 2 or 3 days. You know, sort of, that's probably enough, really. Probably get to see the whole lot.
Yeah.
Well, actually, Dickie, I saw something real disturbing on my last day there.
Oh, dear, what?
Just before I took that tumble. I was walking around on the mountain behind the general store looking for lemons, which I never did find. And I came across this camp, and inside the tent was a man kneeling down, tied to a post, and he looked like he'd been covered in chocolate, melted chocolate.
Oh,
he was all oily and tarry looking.
Was he okay?
No, he was very dead.
Like a greasy black pudding.
It was very disturbing.
Wait, so one more time. Covered in some sort of what?
Like tar, but it was kind of chocolatey looking.
Oh dear.
His entire body.
Dark or milk chocolate?
Dark chocolate.
Yeah.
Well, my least favourite.
Yeah, no one likes dark chocolate. It's disgusting. It's quite bitter.
Yeah. Oh, so, did you speak to anybody before you got on the boat about it?
No, I didn't. I got scared and I went running and I slipped down a ledge and then I was lying there for hours because my ankle was all twisted. And a man called Morgan came and found me.
Oh, Morgan, the English chap, yes?
Yeah, there's the one.
Oh, he seemed very nice.
Yeah, I was real lucky because if the locals had robbed me, I'd have been stuck there for 3 weeks trying to earn the $50 to go back.
Oh, yes. It's a lot of iguanas to kill.
Yeah. A lot of bananas to pick.
Well, I didn't even have any weapons or money.
Oh, dear.
Oh, God. Yeah, so next time, like, the three of us, we've got to, like, stick together then, haven't we? So we can look after each other.
Yes, we should probably make it so that we all sort of set our alarms to wake up at the same time.
Yes.
That's right.
Yeah.
Not go off gallivanting.
Yeah, leaving certain members.
I'm very bad for that. That's why Meg would get so angry at me, because I did go off gallivanting a lot on my own, but I am learning my lesson.
Well, you know, you just got to be careful. I mean, it's fine to go off gallivanting, but you just have to remember safety first. Go on, Dickie.
No, after you, I insist.
Well, I was just going to say, but, you know, if you had, like, me with you or Dickie with you, then, you know, we would have been able to, like, hold you back and say, no, Flo, don't go, Flo, when you're about to go off the cliff, you see. And that might have saved you.
Probably my fault, because I went off to bed just before the fighting, because, yes.
How I did that watch go, some of the fighting, yes. So there was a man who was apparently a professional fighter from Saint Denis.
Oh, that was Ray, wasn't it? The bald chap.
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
Yes,
yeah,
built like he a rich house. Mm-hmm. Oh, he won, did he? Mm-hmm. Oh, that's good, yes.
Yeah, he beat up that beautiful Julius. He beat up someone called Copperhead. He beat up lots of other people.
Yes, it was, was Julius okay, the poor sausage?
Yeah, he was fine.
Oh, good.
We all got loads of medical kits ready to, you know, administer to everyone in the ring.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. The highlight of my week, personally, was the diving competition and being able to spend some time with, Mr. Terran.
Mm-hmm. See, I told, Rodney about Terran oiling himself up with the, blubber.
Yes. Surprised I won. I was so distracted. Mm. It was so obvious.
Was you salivating, Dickie?
No.
Oh, that's good.
I think Dickie was making a very good silhouette when he was diving, you know.
Right.
Yes.
Mm, yes. Lots of protrusions.
Oh.
Yes, yes. Well, I admire the physical form, old boy.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that's why you like me so much, innit? You know.
Yes. Especially Terran. Topless.
Yeah.
But,
is he an older sort of chap, or is he like young like me?
I'd guess he's about 20, late 20s.
Yeah, 30 maybe. He was thin. Yes. His hair was thinning.
Oh, yes, yes.
Mm. He's thinning on top, was he?
Yeah.
Yeah, luckily I don't have that.
No, you've got full thick head of hair. Yeah. We went to the barber's once. Me and Dickie, and Dickie, you know, tried all these different styles. You know, the barber was like zhushing his hair about, saying you can have this one, that one, and there was some like quite strange ones, weren't there, Dickie?
Yes, one of them made me look like my bloody mother.
Yeah, with the moustache and everything.
Oh, yes, she had a moustache as well, yes. The old bum tickler.
Yeah, I think it happens to all ladies eventually.
Yeah.
Well, that means something for me to look forward to then. I hope to grow a big enough moustache that I can put some wax in it, twirl it around.
Yeah.
It'd be good if I get one like yours, Dickie.
Oh, yes. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yes. Well, what are we going to do with ourselves today?
Well, what do you fancy doing?
Well, I've got some herbs on me. I was fancying trying out some tonics to see what the effects were like.
I'll be your test specimen.
Oh, that's good, yeah. So, I mean, each of the tonics, apparently, they can either deplete or restore your stamina, deplete or restore your health, deplete or restore your hunger or your thirst.
Yeah.
And some of them can make you take quite a beating.
Oh, I see.
You know, make you feel very tough so that, you know, you can get punched and not really lose your health.
That'd be worth taking if you went into a fighting competition.
Yeah, exactly.
I suppose if they found that out, they'd probably, you know, wait for it to wear off and then beat the shit out of you.
That's right, performance-enhancing stimulants, you know.
Yeah.
So where are all of these ointments?
I've got to make them.
Oh, I see.
And I've got some in my pouch. I think my horse will be here somewhere. I have to go get him.
And we're going to the apothecary that will be there.
Oh, we could do that, actually, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I don't mind.
That sounds good.
It's got the apothecary. Yeah.
Yes. Mm. Talking of nothing, just an unrelated thing. When I woke up today, all the fucking nutters are out, old boy, in St. Denis.
What do you mean, the fucking nutters? Pardon my pointing mouth.
There's a chap called Mud who works at the Bastille. Either of you are familiar with him?
No.
Well, there I am at the telegram office, responding to all of my love letters, and I see this chap walking down the middle of the street holding a knife, and he's dressed in his sleepwear, you know, a sleep cap, a nightcap, pyjamas, socks with no shoes.
Was it like a red sort of pyjama outfit?
No, it was all blue, actually.
Because there was a fellow that was...
Like the Sissican prison outfit?
No, No. No, no, blue. Like Rodney's, his sort of.
Oh, all blue. Nice.
Pants
stripes.
Were like, yeah, like Rodney's. And he had some blue and white socks on. Anyway, just walking down the street, holding a knife, snoring.
Snoring?
Snoring, yes.
Was he sleepwalking, was he?
Yes, it turned out he was sleepwalking.
Oh, my
God. When he came
God.
Right up behind me with the knife, you see.
Oh, my Jesus Christ, alive. Oh, yes. Pardon my putty mouth.
Yes, and anyway, this other fellow came out of the telegram office and was like, yeah. Mert, what are you doing? And sort of tackled him to the ground because I was just, you know, doing telegrams, minding my own beeswax.
Yeah.
Not knowing this chap had a big knife behind me.
Oh.
Anyway, he woke up. Yes, he woke up. And I said to him, have you been on medication, old boy? And he said, no, I haven't, Dickie. And I said, anyway, this chap took him out to the roads to see a doctor. So
yeah.
I left that. That was one bloody nutter. And then as I come out of roads, I'm heading along the train tracks there. And there's this bloody old woman just walking along the train tracks. I'll do an impression of her walk.
Yeah, please do.
Right. She's walking like this, old boy. No, let me try that again, because need to warm up, you see.
Yeah, that's all right. Okay. Get into the character, Dickie. Maybe you're an actor.
Method actor.
Uh-huh. Like, sort of confused, sort of crazy, like, walk.
Yeah, it's crazy. Anyway, I come up to her and, you know, come up to behind. I'm like, oh, hello, old girl. Are you okay? You're lost. Do you need a ride or something?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And she starts spouting all of this rubbish about needs to go to Poopy Land. I said, Poopy Land? She said, yes, with the mud and the poo. And I said, oh, you must mean Valentine.
Yeah.
And I said, well, hop on, I'll give you a ride, old girl. And she said, no, she wants to walk in case she meets some people. And I said, well, you've met a person.
Yeah.
Get on, I'll take it. Anyway, she started talking some bollocks about shaking leaves and planting of roots. So I said, well, have a good day, and off I went.
Yeah, she sounds a complete fuckcase. Oh, pardon my potty mouth.
Rodney.
Sorry, I can't help it.
Coffee.
Yes, yeah, coffee, so I've still got some caffeine in my system.
Anyway, you know, sometimes I wake up and I see nobody, no one talks to me, and I spend hours just walking around, doing nothing, and the next day I wake up and all the bloody nutters are out.
Well,
I was testing out my tonics yesterday, and
when
I got back in Saint-Denis, and I got into an argument with Nandor, my horse, because one of the tonics did make me think that Nandor was talking bad to me. So I said to him that he had big thighs and he got real angry and kicked me and knocked me out. Luckily, a man along and took me to the doctor's office and helped, you know, get me back on my feet. But while we were in there, this strange-looking man with a kind of a Hispanic accent. His name was Vega, and he had like a white mask on. And he said he had a real badly burned face and could I write a doctor's note for him to say that he had to wear the mask?
Sounds a bit fishy.
But I said, I'm not a doctor, so I can't do that for you.
Yeah,
he said if I could forge one for him, and I said, no, I don't have any doctor's signatures.
He sounds like a ruffian trying it on.
Yeah.
But he's very polite.
Yeah, they're just very tricksy.
Very tricksy.
I was in Annisburg the other day, just finishing a search patrol, and we had to go like to the telegram office just to report in that we're heading back. And my friend Shana, she got robbed, because we were hitching up, and she walked in and said, I'll go and send the telegram. So, you know, bearing in mind we're all in our Ranger gear. And we both walked in behind her, and she's getting robbed. So we both immediately, like, drew our rifles, pointed them at this bloody ruffian's face, and yet he still had the gall to rob her. So we had to, like, lower our rifles because, you know, obviously we don't want her getting shot. And it just fucks me off. Oh, pardon. But honestly, I had him in my iron sights. I would have put one right between his eyes. And it just annoys me how these ruffians just point a gun and that's it. They always win.
Yes. Must be quite frustrating, old boy.
Well, it is, yeah, because, you know, they're my friends and my work colleagues and I don't want them getting robbed. And I'm standing there pointing a gun at this arsehole and, you know, he can still bloody well carry on robbing her.
Yeah, well, that's why I carry sometimes some bad tonics.
Yeah.
Just in case they want to rob me of those tonics.
Yeah. Something that will give them a shit. Labelled.
Yeah. Something that might shoot through the eye of a needle.
Yeah. Like what I'm like when I've had beans.
Oh, yeah, Dickie. Rodney was telling me about his ring of fire.
Oh, yes. Yes, that's concerning.
Yeah, it's the only thing about Guarma is if I had too much fruit, I could be up all night, if you know what I mean.
Yes.
I have to take some steaks.
And you don't
steaks.
Want to be going in the bushes because there'll be snakes and they'll bite you in the air.
And lizards.
Something touched me on my leg when we were walking through the bush, didn't it?
Yeah.
Yes.
And it wasn't tearing.
No, unfortunately.
Yeah, some sort of slivering thing, no doubt.
Yes. Anyway, should we...
Let's go to St. Denis, then.
Yes, indeed.
I do need to go and have a quick tinkle.
Okay. Yeah, me too.
I'm going behind a wagon. That's better.
Lovely.
We just had to be careful in case there's any like wolves when we leave.
Yes.
We heard some wolves. Well, we didn't hear the wolves, but we had
gunshots.
Loads of gunshots. We were like just over the other side of the ridge, you know, where my mother's cross is, and you know, Flo was like telling me all about, you know, Gorma and everything, and we heard these shots, and we couldn't say nothing, so. We rode down in case, you know, someone was hurt, but couldn't see anyone, so a bit strange.
Yes, maybe they got away. Okay.
Yeah, but be careful because there is a lot of criminal activity, especially in Strawberry at the moment, because, you know, I get all the reports from all the rangers. Like the,
Strawberry?
Yeah, the Dead End Gang came in the other day and they shot the place up. They've all been banned from Strawberry. There's been a lot of criminals kidnapping rangers for ransoms and things.
Oh, no.
Oh, dear.
Cat was really badly knifed up by somebody the other day
as
well.
Oh, my God. Okay.
Yeah.
Knifed up?
Yeah, yeah. She was taken hostage, and you know, she's like cut her all up, poor woman. And it's just, yeah, there's been a lot of people like being picked up just because they're Rangers, because we're like an easy target. So we are going to be having like some self-defence classes. But
good.
You know, my theory is they think we're an easy touch. I say we should go fuck them up. If they try it on us, we should just fuck them up. Pardon my point.
Just like if it's law, you know?
Yeah, that's it. They want to try it.
The same respect that you do to law.
We just get the gun out like that and fuck them up.
While you were both having a little
tinkle.
Slash. Oh, a tinkle. I was thinking about this thing about Annisburg where the person pointed the gun. It just sounds a bit strange that they continue to rob even though they had what I assume would be multiple guns pointed out.
Exactly. This is the thing, because there was two fellas in there, right? Obviously, I think they were the same gang. One of them, when me and Crane went walking in there and drew our rifles on this fella, he backed off out. So there was like two guns on this one fella. So really, he should have backed away and not robbed her. But he carried on. And that was what got us really wound up.
Yeah, you know, did you make a report to the government?
Yeah, we did all that, yeah. Mm. And, you know, I wanted to sort of say to her, you know, Shana, drop to the floor. And then if she'd just like, you know, done that,
yeah,
we would have then just like blasted the fuck out of him. But you know, we're not allowed to do it because we're bloody Rangers, aren't we? We have to be good.
Not fair.
Yeah, apparently there was some sort of gang that could sort that sort of thing out.
Yeah, yeah, just really go around fucking up all the arseholes.
Yeah, yeah. Oh well, maybe,
yeah.
Should we go to
Saint Denis? Let's go to Saint-Denis.
Shall we?
Sorry, Flo, after you.
Oh, that's all right. I'm just saying I'm getting very confused studying all these townings.
In what way?
Well, there are just so many and so many combinations.
Well, yeah, I suppose there's a lot, isn't there, of different variants you can have.
Yeah. And sometimes I find it hard to know what the effects are. Because if it's one that means that you can take a beating, then I can't retest it. I tried by jumping off the wall and things, but it's difficult. It's much easier if someone punches you, I think.
I think you need like a couple of you. Yeah. Like at least like three of you, as we
definitely.
Are. So that way, you know, you've always got someone on standby. You know, with a medical kit as well. And
that's
someone,
right.
Obviously, things like that to see how much you can take. You can have a little like punch up, and then that way, see if you know if they work. Because obviously, you want to take the ones that you know recover the health after you've taken some a bit of a beating.
And plenty of coffee.
Yeah, plenty of coffee.
Mm.
Yeah, although that Guama coffee was ever so tasty. It did make me go a little bit mental, so I do apologise. Yeah, I'm sorry about that, Dickie.
Oh, no worries, old boy.
I did, like, lose my shit at part of my potty mouth. Honestly, I've been swearing so much lately, I don't know what's got going on. I think it's because I'm 19 now.
Yeah,
that's it.
You can say what you want.
Yeah, I'm sort of throwing more, like, swear words in. We're going to go along like the coastal path, Dickie.
Yes, might as well. That's my least favourite path in the whole crossing because I've done it so bloody
time. Shall we go across the Heartlands?
Yeah.
All right, let's go the Heartland way. Make a nice change.
Mm.
Oh, What's he got there? Is that oranges?
Oranges.
Oh.
Wow.
That's the same. That's the same fella that just ignored me. I think he's a bit deaf. Taking a left.
Left.
Yeah. Thank you.
I wish I managed to get some lemons, some warmer.
Well, I think that's the place to get them, ain't it? Mm-hmm. I think you can sell them for quite a good profit.
Yeah.
They're very interested in tax, you know, boy. They say you can take,
yeah.
You know, sort of a bunch of six or something.
Yeah.
Oh, a bit of tax, you know, boy.
Oh, really? Mm-hmm. Is it quite strict with their rules then?
No, not really.
No, not at all.
You can't take it all and then because it will sell for quite a very high price. Mm-hmm.
Right.
Yeah, I mean, I could have taken the stuff, but I was not getting searched on my way home.
Right.
Because there was no one to be found.
Right. They'd probably all sleeping off, like, their alcohol abuse.
Mm.
I'm glad you had a nice time, and I'm glad you're both safe. You know, I was worried when you were telling me how hurt you both been, folded and whatnot. We just got to pass
slippery.
This wagon.
Very slippery mountains and hillsides.
Yeah.
Mm.
And of course, Rodney, it would be absolutely wonderful to have you with us next time, but
yeah.
I must say it was a nice opportunity for Snow and I to get to know each other a little bit better.
Yeah. Mm. Oh, yeah. And I say, you know, I was pretty busy and, you know, I couldn't have just sort of like gone and like, you know, the spur of the moment, I suppose, but I would have come with you.
Well, maybe we should plan something a bit far in
advance. This head left.
Mm. No, left.
Yeah, because I do feel like I did not explore enough of it.
Quite.
Yeah, we'll just plan it better. We'll set a date. And the time and everything, so we make sure we catch the boat together.
Mm.
You know.
Perhaps I'll write to Aurelia in advance. Maybe she could show us some of the lessons.
Oh, yeah, she could be a guide for us.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'll slip her, you know, 30 cents or something.
Yeah, don't overdo it. Mm. I know that the rangers are planning on going out there for surveillance of, like, the wild animals and whatnot. So, perhaps like next time they do, because they can only go in groups of four. That's what they've, you know, their allowance. So
yeah.
I'll put my name down for one, and then that'll give you like time to save up your money. Do we want to go down that way? We're going.
I'll follow you, old boy.
All right, let's go left here.
Through the bush.
Let's go back down this way.
She said that I should take some over there.
Oh, yeah, you should. You can sell them.
Mm, yeah.
I bet there's loads of people who want to get off their tits.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know if I could take a crate over there.
I think as long as you are holding on to it very tightly that it doesn't get washed overboard, I think you're all right.
Well, if you can manage with a cup of tea, yeah, well, a cup of coffee.
Yeah. But you might have to look into that from people that have come and gone quite a bit that are doing... Because, you know, there probably is sort of like quite a bit of trade going on, so you need to find out, you know, what the trade restrictions are.
Mm. I just thought of something. Claire, trade your crate of tonics for a crate of lemons.
Oh, yeah.
So how much do lemons sell for over here?
I'm not sure, though, but apparently, you know, Abigail says I'm to sell the small tonics for 25 and the medium ones for 30.
Oh. Mm. Take a left here, Dickie, and it's cut across.
Yes, I'm with you.
Because her rival, I can't remember his name, I think it's something like Frankie or something, he sells tonics from the Bastille, and he is charging $60 per tonic.
$60?
Mm.
Really? So you could like go in and do it like 50?
Well, I mean, Abigail's doing them for 30, about 35, but she does custom ones too, so
yeah.
And those are different prices depending on what people want from them.
Yeah, I mean, the thing is, you don't want to like step on somebody's toes and start pissing people off.
Well, everyone has their own unique recipes.
Yeah.
Including me.
Exactly.
Flo, did you take Aurelio's telegram number when you were there?
I would need to look in my notebook.
Well, if you didn't, I'm sure she wouldn't mind if I gave it to you. To try and arrange something to do with the trading of the tonics, wouldn't that be an interest of yours?
Oh, for sure. I mean, that might even pay for my ticket.
Well, yeah, I mean, you've got to start saving up for it.
Well, I got money in the bank. I can go straight out to Guarmer if I wanted to.
Yeah.
But I do need to be minding the store for
Abigail. How's that all going, your job and that?
Oh, very well. She's in Louisiana at the moment.
Right.
But I think there's been a florist going in there and stealing the flowers.
Really?
So I'm going to need to tell Abigail about that.
Yeah.
Two lily pots were missing.
Right.
And all the books are all messed up.
Yeah. Yeah, that's no good at all.
Nah.
I had to, you both got to keep this a secret, right? I had to do a report for Deuce. Like the senior ranger. Because there was an incident between a couple of rangers. Take a right here, Dickie.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
What happened?
Well, basically, in a nutshell, one of the... We was on a search and rescue, and we went to, a craze something, a craze run, like a lake.
Yeah.
And it's a notorious place for bears, right? And,
Are we
going
to Rhodes?
That's what I was thinking. Did we want to go to Rhodes? I can't remember now. Oh, sorry, that's my bad. Well, we'll just cut through Rhodes. Slide down to town. There's a lot more dogs here now, aren't there?
Yeah.
That one looks like a pup.
There's so much shit around here.
I know, it's a mixture of horse and dog shit. Look at that pile, that was absolutely festering. I might have to bring Hazel back and let him run free around Strawberry. What do you think, Dickie?
What's that? Hazel?
Yeah, I might bring him back to Strawberry, let him run around in the fields.
Yes, might as well, old boy. That stable at the top there looks lovely.
Yeah, and this place is a bit full of, like, shit, isn't it?
Yeah. So tell us more about this ranger incident, please.
Yeah, so anyway, we was on this search and rescue, and we come to that lake, and it is, like, notorious for bears.
Yeah.
So I sort of, like, said, right, let's all get our binoculars out, and let's just scout it for bears, you know, before we went round it. You know, we know that the person that was injured wasn't spotted near water, but it was, like, on our route.
Yeah.
And before we could do anything, one of the rangers, and he ain't a recruit, he is a ranger, just starts like swimming across on his horse to fight this bear because we spotted a bear. What are you doing? So the rest of us had to then rush round on our horses to get round the other side. And when we was going round the other side, a bear attacked us out of nowhere.
Oh,
and you know, I was blasting it, and then it chased this like Shayna, and she was like,
Shayna's having a real bad time with it,
And so, like, yeah, she managed to get up on this rock, and the bear went round the other side of the rock, so I couldn't get any more shots off at it. And she managed to shoot the thing, and she was absolutely livid. But she was, like, calm with it, but I could tell she was really pissed off. And she said that was, like, the third time now he's done that, gone off on his own.
Oh, that's not good.
And, you know...
Trying to be a hero.
Yeah, exactly. So she like had a go at him, but she was very calm. She didn't sort of shout or, you know, she was firm with him and put him in his place. And I just said to him, I said, look, we got to stick together in a group. We can't just go off on our own because it's dangerous. And he just sort of seemed to like, you know, laugh about it. You know, a bit of a smirk on his face when he was like, what's the problem, you know?
Oh, dear.
Anyway, next thing I know, like a couple of days have passed and I go and read my telegrams and there's one there from Deuce saying, can you give me a full report on the incident between, like, the two rangers? So, like, they're like, you know, sort of think hard on what had happened.
Yeah, and,
on him. Okay. And, yeah, and then I had to sort of give a detailed report, and I basically sort of said what I told you. So he just said he wanted us, like, get a full report to make sure that no one was lying. So he's probably heard one story from him and a story from her, and, you know, obviously my story's going to back hers up.
Do they
but,
kill face discipline?
Yeah, I reckon so.
Especially
if
it's
so.
Third time.
Well, she's reported him before, and she said
that... Oh, it's good that she's reported him before, and there's some backup then.
Well, she said that she wasn't going to report this time, but she said this is the third time you've done it, and she said, I have reported one of the incidents, but I'm not going to do it this time. You know, you got to stop, like, doing these bloody crazy things. And,
I wonder how he knows him.
I don't know. You know, I don't know what the outcome will be, whether they'll, like, just kick him out, or they'll say, you're on...
Left, I think.
Okay, you're on, like, probation, and one more fuck-up and you're out. Because what can they do? They can't just make him go back to recruit.
No.
I think I might have taken a wrong turn.
I think we're going into the dangerous bit.
Turn around?
Yeah, sorry, my fault.
That's alright.
It's very confusing around here.
Yeah, do you know what? This is one area I've not really patrolled. I don't really know my way around here.
Flo and I were up here getting
Look at that crocodile. That's disgusting. The way it runs. Horrible thing.
Oh, yeah.
He's going away. Go on, it's okay, mister. There's nothing to see. Don't get all arsey.
Yeah, be gone with you.
You alright, Dickie? Yeah. Did you have some coffee?
There was another one there on the water.
Oh yeah.
Horrible things.
On the bridge, look, see it? Another one up there.
It's real creepy the way they ran.
Yeah, looks a bit weird.
Yeah, we were up here collecting eggs.
Oh, yes, eggs and the blood orange.
Oh, yeah, that's where I had my full-cooked breakfast, wasn't it?
Yes, your birthday.
Yeah, that was lovely. Do you know what I was thinking about that the other day? Thinking how nice that was.
Yes. Again, like many places, I feel like we only, you know, touched the surface with the swamp when you and I went out there. Flo, I think there's probably much more to discover.
Oh, definitely.
This is definitely the place I'd like to patrol, so, you know... We should come out here and explore a bit then, find out. I know there is like cougars about, or panthers, swamp panthers, so we do have to be careful about them. I'm not sure where they are, but it would be good for me. Do you know where they are?
Yeah, I know all about that panther.
I think there's a few.
It got me the other day.
Really? Oh, my God.
The night before we went to Guarmer. So I went out to Guarmer with nothing, not even a canteen.
Oh my God. So did you have to go out to the bank and get more money, or, I mean, you know, for your ticket? Oh, blimey.
Yeah. It was horrible. I was collecting herbs in the swamp, and my horse, he got a bit upset, and I thought, oh, what's wrong with you? And I didn't see any snakes, and then he suddenly just bolted me off, and I couldn't hear nothing. And then I went to get it, and all of a sudden, I felt these scratches on my back.
Oh my God.
And then I woke up in some hut in the swamp, and the locals had robbed me.
That's terrible.
Said it was a panther that had got me.
Yeah. Well, this is it. We got, you know, got to stick together. you know, you...
But it was so silent. I never heard anybody. You know how I hear a cougar?
Yeah, I know, but...
I think it jumped out the tree at me.
You can ask the rangers for escorts, you know that, can't don't you? You can, they, you know, they will come and take you out to places and look after you.
Oh, that's good. Really? Maybe I'll do that.
Yeah.
Nandor must be around here somewhere. I'm just going to call him. Nandor!
It's good to see you again, Dickie. I have missed you.
Yes, and you are by, I missed you. Sounds like you've been keeping yourself well, though.
Yeah, just honestly, just so busy. You know, I was starting to flow. Yes. The other day, you know, I was just there on my own and I had, like, deputies talking to me about a tip. I had some mad random person that had a bald head that I couldn't tell whether it was, like, a fella or a lady. And then I saw Flo and I couldn't even sort of, like, speak to Flo because, the bell was ringing in the station and I had to go and get another tip and it was like too much. Yeah.
Yes, I think there was a day where I rode past. I think you were there, old boy, but... There was about six or seven people there all engaged in conversations. I just kept going.
Right. Oh, you should have come over and said hello, you know.
Well, no, you looked like you were a very busy old boy. And,
Like I say, you know, there's been a lot of shit going down in Strawberry, you know, with, like, ruffians coming in, basically, and robbing us blind, you know.
Yes.
I told
I
told you about Alfred getting robbed, didn't I? And Deuce and Buzz getting robbed on the porch by one man.
Oh, dear.
Oh my God.
He walked round the back of the station, pointed the gun at Alfred's head, and robbed all three of them. And this is, the thing that annoys me.
He has no value of his own life there, thinking he can take on three people.
Exactly. Yeah, and I just sort
it's getting sad.
Yeah, it's pissing down. Come on, Dickie. I like this shop. I think it's probably one of my favourite places in the crossing.
Oh, it is so beautiful.
Yeah.
Right. Well,
I just love all the stained glass. Look at
the stained glass is so pretty.
The lovely blues.
Yeah, that big mirror. Nice and clean.
Oh, look.
There's a phonograph there.
I never noticed that. Look. All three of us together.
What a bunch.
Yeah.
Bunch of bloody old reprobates, that's for sure.
Yeah. I do like the hats. Are they for sale, are they, or just for, like, show?
I'm not sure, to be honest. We did have an inquiry from a lady who wants to sell her hats in here. She's a milliner.
Oh.
She's a what?
A milliner. Someone who makes hats.
I thought it was a hatter.
I think that's the
millionaire. I was about to say, let me know. No, I want to see who this person is.
These hats would look good on you, Dickie.
I beg your pardon. Maybe in a player.
That one there would, you know, just up there, the green one. That top hat, that would look good on you.
That'd look like a right top hat.
Yeah.
Oh, there's some Earl Grey tea there if you want some.
Oh, don't mind if I do.
What's your favourite hat, Flo?
My favourite hat?
Yeah.
Oh, out of those, I think those are all a little bit too fancy, but I do quite like this one on the end right here, just above Dickie. The one right at the end, the dark one, that looks like it's got a dead bird on it.
The green one.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that is nice. That's a bit more classy, ain't it? I quite like the one next to it with the purple plumage.
Oh, I don't like the hot pink.
Oh, right, yeah.
Fuchsia pink is not my colour. I like muted colours.
Yeah. That's quite a classy one, isn't it? With the white plumage. Like, you know, with the way it's sort of like curved up on a jaunty angle.
Oh, it's a nice angle, but I don't like the frill.
Sorry, I feel like I heard somebody scream just then.
Oh.
What? So it's crossing range, your car. There's people over there, but I think they're just local people.
I heard somebody scream.
You sure it weren't just like the lightning or something?
Might have been a
horse. It wasn't a horse.
Might have been a horse, actually.
Yeah, there's a horse neighing at the moment.
Oh, do apologise for getting everybody wet.
It's nice, it really smells nice, doesn't it? What are these lilies, are they? I think the lilies are really nice.
Right, okay, let me make some tonic scene.
Yeah. Don't let your tea get cold, Dickie.
Oh, well.
Oh, sorry. Look at the rain out there.
Oh, yeah, it's really coming down some, isn't it?
Yeah. Cats and dogs, that is.
No, I think it's water, actually.
Oh. Hello, Rodney. Hello, Rodney. Just admiring myself in the mirror.
Oh, yeah.
Hello, sir. That's a nice top hat. I like this bit in here of all the botanical stuff. Lickety Splick Elixir.
So this one I've got is Texas Bluebonnet. You know what we found on the Great Plains?
Right.
Near Blackwater. I haven't tested this one out yet. Now, should I drink it or do one of you want to drink it?
I don't do drugs, just say no.
Oh, okay.
I'll have it.
Oh,
yeah,
right.
Dickie and, don't mind, he drinks anything.
How's your stamina on your heart at the moment? You might need to kind of get them back down to half so that we can see the effects.
I see.
Before you drink it, yeah.
What's he got to do?
Get his stamina down a bit and his heart down, his health.
Mm. I might have to punch him.
Yeah, I think you will.
It's
yeah.
Probably better if you hit him, because I might hurt him.
Punch me.
Oh,
no. Oh, shit, I didn't realise I had that equipped.
Steady, old girl. It took my knee out. Oh, nice little flourish now.
I've never punched anyone. How do I get my fists out?
Let me do it. Stand aside.
Yeah. Rodney, you know how much I appreciate you, old boy. Oh, oh, bloody hell.
Is that all right?
About five more, old boy. Oh, bloody hell. One more.
Is that all right? I'm sorry.
One more, old boy. Big one. Oh, dear. Right,
yeah.
Okay. Oh, dear.
Oh, all right, Dickie, come here. Let me give you this drink. Yeah.
Hmm. Oh, damn.
If it kills him, I've got a bag. I can revive him if it knocks him out.
Right, up your bum.
Good luck.
No harm done.
What do I need to
run around or get maybe Rodney to hit you. Oh, you're very fast.
Yeah,
oh,
you're faster than normal.
Very fast.
Punch me.
Punch him.
Come on, you pussy.
Run out of the way, Flo.
Come on, you pussy. Hit me. Bloody.
How's that?
Oh, I feel marvellous.
Oh.
You all right?
So,
how'd you feel?
I'd say no different.
Oh,
to
right.
As if I was running or getting hit before.
But it made you run very fast.
Yeah, definitely. You was like
your learning was real fast.
Yeah. look a spring cheater.
Oh dear, it's out of my blood.
Ow.
Yeah.
No, I'm okay, old boy.
I did keep my gloves on, so I didn't break the skin.
Yes. Oh, there we go. Oh, I feel wonderful.
So what would that one do? What did that do then? Just make him faster? Did it have any effect on your...
Yeah. Did it make you have blurred vision?
Yeah, so blurred vision. But well, I've had other drugs before, as you know. But and sometimes my side of my vision is like orange or purple, but this was just quite normal. Mm. Just a greyish blur around my eyes.
Uh-huh.
I felt like... I used the same amount of stamina to run, but usually I appear to run faster, and that's good.
Yeah, real fast.
But each punch hurt just like without having it.
Right, so I think that just makes you run real fast then.
Yeah.
That's good to know. I will get more of those. Yeah. That could be very helpful, and I know how to get rid of the blurred vision effect.
So do you have to take another one or add another ingredient?
Yeah, you add another special ingredient.
Oh. Mm. It's very interesting, all this potion making.
Are you recording all of this, Flair, so you can publish it?
Not so that I can publish it, though.
No.
It's like top secret. That no one can know about this. So, Rodney, don't tell any of your ranger pals.
Tell them what?
Exactly.
Yeah. Mum's the word.
Mm. Yeah.
Yes.
So that was a good one, eh? Right, okay. I need to think of a neurotonic that I've got here. And who wants to test it out once I've made it?
What's this one do?
Oh, I don't know yet.
I'll test it. If you like.
What happened to I don't do drugs.
Well, I don't do drugs, but, you know, I'm sort of helping out for, you know, experimental purposes. This isn't like recreational, you know, off my tits drugs, is it?
No. Mind you, I do love that old boy.
Yeah. I know you do. So, should I run around first so you can see how fast I go?
Yeah.
Right, I'll run around.
You okay, Flo? Yeah. Moment now.
Has happened a few times to me.
Oh, I see. Mm. Oh, please let me.
I was very fast, wasn't I?
Yeah. So Dickie needs to hit you a few times as well.
Okay. Oh.
I'm sorry, old boy. I was a bit keen.
Let me give you the time.
And again.
What's that? Hang on, did you say? Oh, sorry.
Once more.
Yes. Oh, have some of that.
That'll do.
No.
Ow. All right.
I'm sorry, old boy. Okay. Oh, you need to have the tonic.
Yeah, I need to give you the tonic.
Oh, yeah, sorry about that.
Come here, Rodney.
Go on, Rodney.
I'm trying.
So right. This one is a herb that I found in the swamp.
Okay, it won't make me shit myself in front of you, will it?
I hope not.
So do I.
I hope so.
It goes nothing.
Yes.
Oh. Right, shall I try running around?
Yeah. He's not running. Is he running faster? Not really.
Yeah. No, I'm not running any faster. I'm... ow! Now, don't be careful, because...
I'm sorry, old boy.
Yeah, I'm teetering.
That didn't help, no?
No, that's done nothing.
I think if you punch him, you punch Dickie.
Yes, punch me, old boy.
Maybe you punch him forward.
Oh.
Does that do any...
Yes.
Does that hurt more?
That definitely hurt more. Give me one more, old boy. And again. One more. I feel like the first couple of punches hurt more, but then the last couple didn't.
Oh, wow, that's interesting.
Doesn't last very long.
No. Oh, dear.
I feel quite fucked.
Yeah.
Oh, dear.
Only small experimental ones, because otherwise, if I want a long-lasting one, I'd need 10 of each herb.
Should I bandage up, or should I stay sort of quite fucked?
You can both bandage up for a bit, because
okay.
I'm going to have to just go off for 10 minutes and come back.
10 minutes?
Yes. While I mix up some other herbs.
Right, okay.
But I'll be back in 10 minutes.
Okay.
Why don't you treat yourself to something nice to eat at the at Lydia's?
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Would you like a bandage?
No, I'm okay. Oh, boy, I hurt his nails. If we got 10 minutes, Rodney, I wouldn't mind going down to the convenience store.
Yeah, sounds good. All right, Flo, we'll be back in about, like, 5-10 minutes then. I hope I didn't hurt you, Dickie.
No, I'm fine. Are you okay, old boy?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Oh, I didn't feel very good about doing that, you know.
No, it feels a bit weird, don't it?
Yes.
Yeah, I don't really know what that one did to me.
No, you didn't appear to run any faster than
before. No. No, and I don't know if my punches hurt any more than normal, did they? Did it sort of feel like I was hitting you harder?
The first couple did, but then the others didn't. Did it wear off as you were hitting me?
No, it had all, you know, it was still going while I was still hitting.
Yes.
So perhaps it's just the first couple, I don't know. It's a bit hard to define, isn't it?
It is rather. A trial and error, that's science, I assume.
Yeah.
Left heel.
Taking a left third. Yeah, boy. Sorry, go on. No, it's all right.
I was going to say I never see anybody in the Blue Pearl, that public house back there.
Well, I think it's a bit of a shithole, ain't it?
Yeah.
So it's probably just as well. Probably full of ruffians.
What are we going to say, old boy?
Oh,
sorry, everybody.
Hello. I was going to say, you know, we're going to get the, you know, the self-defence training. I'll be able to teach you and Flo some stuff.
Yes, that would be quite fun, actually. I wouldn't mind learning. It's been a long time since I did a spot of boxing.
I learnt the other day how to, when someone points a gun at you, how to take it out of their hand.
Oh, yes.
So that's a good one to know.
Oh, yes. Maybe you could write it down for me at some point.
Yeah, I will do.
Right, let's have a look here. One newspaper, please. And cigarettes, please. Thank you. What else do I need? Oh, dear.
They sell pomade here.
Yes, that's what I was looking for, old boy. Hair pomade.
Yeah, oh, hair pomade, righto. Oh,
maybe
yeah,
not.
Yeah. What do they stack in? 5 or 10?
Do you know, you can go up to... Yes, 10, yes, 10.
Yeah, I was showing it off, like, at the range station the other day. My, I was saying it's like my hair's like spun gold.
Oh, indeed.
Yeah, I'll just have a look what they got here. Animal glue. Oh, you probably used to be a horse, didn't it?
Yes. Stephen.
Did you? You didn't, did you?
No, because Flower's going to use Stephen to store a crate, you know, in his...
Oh, yeah, you're going to, like, hand over the documents, aren't you?
Yes, when she gives me the $100, but I think Guama took it out for a bit, old boy.
I'm going to make some chocolate milk for us, because I think that'll help us with our getting our energy back.
Yeah, it's good thinking, old boy.
Bloody pocket space is always a nightmare, ain't it?
I've got plenty of need or something, old boy.
If I can just give you Flo's bottle back, that'd be right
yes,
handy.
Yes, of course. Yeah. Oh, I've finally discovered how to reach out without sticking my fingers, you know?
Oh, right, yeah. So, yeah, that's good to know you've finally worked out that simple thing.
Yes, after 6 months, yes.
Yeah. Did you just, like, focus in on it?
No.
Oh. Right, let me just make these chocolate milks, otherwise my pockets are just absolutely bulging. And you don't want to see my pocket bulging, do you?
No. Do you know Flo? Are you familiar with her?
Yeah, I know her.
Yes, Flo from the Apocryphathui. When we were on Guamar, I sort of asked her if she, you know, just in conversation, if she had any, you know, feelings for you, more than a friendship.
Right, yeah.
Because I know you thought maybe something might happen. How do you feel about that, old boy?
Yeah, no, well, I do like her, you know. And obviously, you know, I've, like, kissed her cheek twice, you know.
Yes.
Upper left cheek.
Oh, yes.
So, what does she say?
She looks to you like a brother or a slightly disabled cousin.
Is that what she said?
No, that was just my words, old boy. She said...
You cheeky fucker. Oh, on my potty mouth.
She said she thinks of you like a brother.
Right.
And that we are a family.
Yeah.
Now, I know that might be disappointing to you, old boy, but...
No, it's fine.
See it this way, old boy. It means that we are family, you know, and we will always be family.
Yeah.
And it will never... tear us apart, you see, because the thing with relationships, old boy, is, sometimes they start off very well and they don't end particularly well, and it ruins the friendship.
Yeah. Well, this is the thing, you know, when we had this, you know, remember we used to have the nice gazebo chats, which, you know, we should still do from time to time, you know.
Yeah.
That I did sort of think, you know, when I was thinking about, you know, Bright Dawn and all that, that it would be just awkward if, like, we fell out, you know what I mean? So I didn't really want to go there with any, like, rangers in case it did get awkward. But that's fine with Flo because, you know, I'd rather keep her as a friend forever than a lover for a short time, if that makes sense.
Yes.
And the fact that she looks at me as a brother, I don't want it to get incesty.
Oh, no. No, not at all. But, yes, I mean, you know, those trousers are very tight, you know. So you can almost read her lips, if you get what I'm saying, old boy.
Yeah. Yeah, like sort of lip reading.
Yes, indeed.
Yeah, sort of. I don't quite understand.
Yes, never mind.
I'm going to make some more chocolate milk so I can give Flo some.
Oh, yes.
I know it's probably because I'm not manly enough for her, but that's fine.
She said she likes people with dark hair. I thought that's a bit shallow and specific.
Well, yeah, I mean, my hair's like spun gold. What the fuck am I supposed to do about that? Put coal in my hair?
Yes. I did say to her, oh, what about silver hair? No, I didn't really, old boy. yes, she's like a daughter I wish I didn't have. Talking of children, old boy.
Yes.
I got a very queer telegram from Maxwell.
Oh, yeah.
Saying, I found your son. That's all it said. And I responded and said, I don't have a son. What are you bloody talking about?
Well, yeah. Yeah, mind you, you probably have put your like seed about in quite a few people's pockets, haven't you?
I've had my fair share, yes.
Well, you get about a bit, don't you? I mean, you're not called the Silver Fox for nothing.
Well, exactly. Well, you know, it's been a while for old Dickie, but, yeah, in my youth.
Yeah. Yeah, well, yes. You know, I mean, we saw what you looked like when you was, like, you know, younger, didn't we? You know?
Oh, yes.
With your long hair and that, you look fan-fucking-tastic.
Thank you. Oh, my God, what happens if I do have a son and he's here in the crossing?
Well, it'd be good. He might be into the theatre like you.
Oh, dear.
Get out of your way.
No, I'm done here, Bob.
I'm gonna have a chocolate milk because I feel fucked. Oh, honestly, I'm swearing like a docker.
Yes.
Oh, that's better. That's gone up a bit, yeah. I feel a bit more energised now.
Oh, that's good.
I think I'll have something to eat as well. I might just have a bar of chocolate. That's got to be good, isn't it?
Well, the sugar in it's good, old boy, but you can't just live off chocolate milk and chocolate.
Well, I like it.
You need some meat in your boy.
Well, I've got meat in me.
Oh, indeed. Is that what the rangers get up to, is it?
Well, we kill a lot of animals, so I've always got, like, meat on me.
Yes.
And so I'm always eating it, so it's always in me.
Oh, that's very true. Yes.
I don't, you know, yeah, ooh, that's better, yeah. Although I think a bit of steak would right help at the moment, because I am feeling quite like a bit anemic.
Oh, dear. Oh, look, there's a sign here. This sign here.
Yeah, what's it say?
Peregrine's Posies and the Penny Shell Market in Delhi. This person called Peregrine, she's a fine filly.
Oh.
Yes.
That's nice.
And, oh, look there. And Charity Smith, I don't know Charity Smith, but Peregrine Hawthorne, she attended a drama club one time. She's very shy, but very pretty right. Girl. Yes.
Oh, is that the one that awful walrus man was, she was working for?
Oh, no, that's Miss Turner, shakes like a leaf. Oh, no, that's somebody different.
Poor cow. She was telling me how addicted to all these drugs she is.
Oh, she's a fucking mess, old boy.
Really?
Yeah, quite a mess. Are you done here?
Yeah, I'm all done, yeah. Let's go back.
Now I need to check my telegram. I think we've been less than 10 minutes.
That's all right. Oh, look, we're keeping the road blocked up.
Hello.
Sorry, mister.
Sorry, mister.
All right, calm down. Christ, honestly, Dickie, some people are just complete arseholes.
Yeah, bloody saint in here, protect.
Yeah.
You know, talk for itself.
Yes, indeed. May I?
I'm just putting in the finishing touches.
Okay, oh boy.
Aha.
You know what I said about the fucking nutters, old boy?
Yeah.
Plan.
Yeah. What's your name again, old boy? The night wolf?
No. I'm the impractical jokester.
Yes, indeed. May I?
Oh, yes, of course.
Am I?
Take a sip. It's free.
I don't want to.
Go on, take a sip.
Wait, what do you want for it? There's got to be some sort of game.
No, it's free.
Okay. Well, up your bum.
Yeah.
Oh, dear.
My. How'd you feel?
Oh, I feel...
Are you off your tits? God. Dickie.
Oh, yes.
Oh, am I in heaven?
Heaven, maybe.
Have you gone wibbly wobbly, Dickie?
Oh, dear.
Oh, my. Why don't you have a sip as well? No. Join the laughter.
No. Just say no.
Just say no.
Help me out, Rodney. Dear, the cold, the fool's cold, old boy.
Oh, yes, help you up. Cold.
Ready, in three.
So cold.
One, two, three.
Oh, dear.
I hope you enjoyed that one.
Oh, dear.
Well, that's my first impractical joke for this whole charade.
Yes, indeed.
Oh, God.
Oh, no, I think I'm okay. Oh, dear.
Do you want me to hold your hair?
Just hold the moustache on either side.
Oh, my God.
Oh, chundering like thunder.
Oh, I think that got it. Oh, dear, that's better. Oh, look.
Oh, Dickie, you're all in a mess. He's having a great time, look, this fella.
Oh,
these practical jokes.
A splendid time.
Yeah.
Oh, why is it so fluorescent green? Oh.
It must have been that funny tonic you had earlier.
Oh, dear.
Wash it down with a chocolate milk.
Oh, I don't want it to curdle, old boy.
No, it might do. It might come back out your nose.
Yes. I say, what's in this?
Oh, many, many, many things, you know. Barley, wheat, water, sugar. Oh, and maybe some added special ingredients as well.
Like what?
Oh, things that make you laugh like a hyena.
Oh, I say. Oh. Everything seems much brighter and... Rodney...
That is the sun coming up, so it probably would seem a bit brighter.
I never realised...
Yeah.
Is that what's in it?
You didn't put a dog turd in, did you? You didn't put a white dog turd in. One of those special magical... Yeah, the magical white dog turd.
Oh, maybe a white dog turd, maybe as well. I was fishing in the swamps for the water.
Oh, dear. This is going to affect me. No, I'm okay. I thought I was going to go again.
Hold it in.
Yes, what did you...
Swallow it.
What did you put in? What did you put in this?
Maybe a smidge of stallion piss.
Oh, I say...
Just a smidge.
Oh, Rodney, let's go. Oh.
Yeah, I think we should. I think, yeah.
No, you're a monster.
Take care. How do you feel, Dickie? So all the crazies have left Valentine and come to St. Denis then, have they?
Oh, full of fucking mentals, old boy.
He did seem very mental.
I saw him yesterday. Oh. Do you know what's really strange about this?
What?
I'm auditioning to play him in a play. Can you believe that?
Really?
Yes.
Well, perhaps you should, hang around with him and learn his habits.
And well, I was thinking that, but I don't want to get bummed.
Well, yeah, that might
you
be
look
the...
like the type.
Yeah, that might be the price you have to pay.
Yeah, well, it's all in a day's work, old boy.
Yeah, you know, to unlock his secrets of his character, you might have to let him, he might give you a reach around.
Well, small consolation, old boy.
Yeah, he did have gloves. I wouldn't associate with him because I think sooner or later he's going to get nicked by the law.
No, definitely.
You know, if he's putting special dog turds in drinks, then that can't be good.
No, indeed. Oh dear, you see what I mean about the bloody nut jobs?
Yeah. I mean, his outfit was like, you know, right in your face, weren't it?
Oh, yeah. Oh, did you know the sugar cane fields up here? If we just mash them up in a pestle and mortar, old boy, and get the sugar for the horse.
Well, I was after the hay, because I think you get the hay from it, don't you?
Really?
Yeah, was you getting hay?
From the sugar cane.
Yeah, I'm sure someone told me that's where you get it. We'll have to check out the field because, like, I've run out of hay and I'm having to buy apples and it's a right pain in the arse. And
wait, where are you getting the hay from?
Well, the Ellie, the ranger, she was getting it and she was like giving me bundles of 25 at a time.
Did you ask her how she got it?
Yeah, she said, like, sugar cane.
Oh.
But I don't know how she got it from sugarcane.
Hello.
But I might know. Do you know how to get hay?
I think you have to do wheat and sugar and mix it up with your mortar and pestle.
Right.
Oh, that's good to know.
Max makes a hay cube.
Right.
Very good to know.
Yeah.
Oh, good.
Okay, I have a couple more tonics. I do need you to beat each other up again.
Oh, God.
Mm.
Okay. I'll take my weapons off again.
Well, what I do, actually, yeah, if I give you the tonic each first, don't drink it, do the beating up, and then drink it immediately afterwards.
Who's getting beaten up? Mm. I don't mind
both of you
getting a fist.
Beating each other up.
Oh.
Are we both
give
taking
each other
a tonic,
fist,
are we?
Yeah.
Oh. Give me a tonic then, bro.
Do you want the empty bottles, Flo?
That's chocolate
yes,
milk
please.
For you.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, the empty bottles will be handy. Thank you.
Lovely.
I don't know if I've got any room. I've got, like, oodles of chocolate milk.
Thank you. So beat each other up and then drink.
Have we got the same one or not?
No, you got different ones.
Look, I'm going to have to give you something else.
Okay.
More chocolate milk, just so I can take my knife off and I won't cut Dickie up.
Okay.
Right, so
now
we've got to have a...
one person has the silky red tonic, and that's you, Rodney.
Right.
And Dickie has the watery blue, I think.
Right.
Is that right?
Let's go over here.
Yes.
Just so we're...
like a watery blue sort of thing, yes.
Don't choke me. Don't choke me.
All right, I'm not going to. Ow. Ow, my beautiful face. My beautiful face. Oh, I'm sorry about you bastard. Hitting me. Oh, nice swing. Oh, but. Get up, pussy.
That'll do ya. How you doing?
Oh.
Can you take more?
I get very aggressive, old boy. No point.
And right. Well, now have you drunk your tonics and then start fighting with each other as well?
Up your bum, old boy. Well, not you personally.
What's this fella want?
Nothing to see here, sir. It's okay. We're just testing medications.
Punch me.
I can't.
What?
No. I'm here.
Oh, watch out.
Let me try and
fucking yeah, how old is that old girl?
Oh, every time I chuck them, she's gone mad. Dickie, every time.
What are you doing?
I can't. If every time I try and punch you, it makes me throw up. Oh, I don't like this one. I don't like this one. If I try and punch you again, I'll be sick.
The thing's worn off. Things worn off now, old boy.
Yeah. Right. What did you gather from that?
Oh, no. I don't know. What did you get, Dickie?
Well, I mean, nothing really happened because no one could punch me in the face for some reason. But I got a bit of red vision around my eyes. Sort of
okay.
Really. Yes, and, well, I can't give you any more, old girl. I don't know what happened.
That's okay. Yours, actually, I put a special ingredient in yours to make sure that you didn't throw up. So, that worked.
Oh.
That's good.
And how's your health?
Wonderful.
Okay. Aren't we full, or is it still kind of depleted?
Yes, a little bit depleted, but almost, I'd say about, I feel 90% fit, I'd say.
Yeah, same here.
Right, and with other than the vomiting, anything else happen, Rodney?
Like a red blurry vision for when I first drank it.
Okay. So blurry vision and vomiting.
Yeah, and every time I tried to eat him, I just felt like, whoa, I'm going to be sick. And I was. And all that chocolate milk I had all come out my nose.
Oh, no. But your health is okay.
Yeah, well, it's about 90%. Like, I feel, healthy.
Oh, that's good. So, neither of you lost any health then from those two?
Yeah. No.
But Dickie was saved from vomiting, and you weren't.
No, I didn't like that. Dickie can have the vomity one next time.
Ow.
Although he did just like vomit at the telegram office quite badly, so...
Oh, yes.
Do you think that nothing had nothing left to do with it, Dickie? That he didn't have anything left?
Yes, nothing left in me.
Oh, dear.
Yeah.
Right, let me make another one. Hang on.
Oh, God. I don't know if I can do many more of these.
Yeah,
I'm not going to shit myself next time, am I? Just so you can have a giggle.
No.
I'm up for more, old girl.
Oh, okay, right. 1 minute in.
I'll have one more and then that'll be the end of it. Do you want your bottle back?
Yeah, in a minute.
Okay. Oh, what's in the newspaper, Dickie? Anything good?
The Saints Crossing. What's the DH? The Saints Crossing.
Dental Health?
Oh, maybe. Citizens of St. Cross are encouraged to participate in a blood testing clinic to see if you can be a universal donor. Donors are able to save lives. Please consider getting tested. This month is also community outreach. Come and meet the staff and get to know those heroes of the state. Well, I never fucking see any of them. There are two times to attend. May the 6th, that's 3 days' time.
Yeah.
2 p.m., that's 7 p.m. in Old Money. At the medical office in Rhodes.
Yeah.
Law went to war with the Del Lobos.
The Del Lesbos.
Yes, the Del Lesbos wanted to take over BW,
Blackwater,
and install a new government. However, they knew that they couldn't win a war, so decided to go up to Coulter to face off with the law.
Oh.
The battle went on for hours with 20 law present, even bringing a Maxim gun.
Oh, that's like a minigun, isn't it? Like one of them, Gatling gun things.
Oh, lovely. Many were injured before the Lesbos were defeated, with two of the criminals succumbing to their injuries. Perhaps this will end the Del Lobos' reign of terror.
Oh, do you know what? I do like the way you read out the newspaper.
Yes.
You do give it a lot of gravitas.
Yeah, very. You could be a good, you could read the newspaper on stage.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Experience the Wild West in Tumbleweed. This small town has it all. A well-stocked general store, an active gunsmith, a friendly saloon, and a mine. The gunsmith repairs and crafts firearms, while the saloon's locals share stories of their adventures. The mine offers insight into precious metal extraction. The rugged terrain can be challenging, but the stunning views make it worthwhile. Don't miss Tumbleweed, a must visit for Western adventure.
It's an absolute shithole.
Yes, I've seen.
We never got that far, did we, old boy?
No, I've been there a few times and there's nothing there. They're talking a load of shit, pardon my potty mouth, but they are talking out their arseholes. Oh, sorry, yeah. I've done it again.
Dear.
Right, more drugs.
Okay, so you both need to... Well, let me give you the medications first, so...
Righto, I'll give you the empty back. Right, this better not be one of your tricksy ones.
Oh, I hope not. Well, this one.
She's laughing, Dickie. It's a tricksy.
What is it?
This is the blood orange flower. Well, blood flower, but I've been calling it blood orange, and so is Sir Dickie.
Yes.
Right, okay. Do we...
Then we give one to Dickie.
Are you okay, Flo?
She's smiling. Yeah. She's laughing. She's tricksy.
Yes. If you are in the business of punching me in the face, make sure you take all your guns off your gun belt.
Yeah, before you blast his face off. That was very dangerous.
Oh, here, let me take it there.
Yes,
and then... And your knife as well, in case you get that out and start trying to slice us up.
Not my beautiful face.
Yeah.
And then really fucking fight with a capital F, I think.
Yeah, I've taken my binoculars out of my belt as well, just in case I lamp you with
those. Yes. Right. Go on then.
Okay.
On the chin. Oh, dear.
Oh.
Oh, bloody hell. Oh, yes. That'll do.
That means stop, Flo.
Yes.
Don't get carried away with bloodlust.
And what about you, Rodney?
I suppose you better give me a good hiding. Don't choke me! Don't choke me!
Now I say...
Oh,
can feel my heart beating really fast. Don't worry about him. Smack me. Smack me.
Continue the experiment. I don't want to do this one again.
That'll do. That'll do. No effect. Although I am feeling particularly...
Oh, I'm sorry, Rodney. I didn't realise I didn't know what I was strength.
Your eyes went crazy. Like some mad fucker.
It was that Gwarmy's coffee.
Yeah, it's in your system.
Yeah, where's Dickie? Oh, God. He's out.
Oh, my God.
Oh, poor Dickie. I'm going to have to attend to him.
I don't like these experiments.
I mean, you haven't even taken your tonic yet.
Oh, no. Just say no.
I'm just helping Rodney.
No, I'm fine. I'm just having a lay down.
Oh, good.
You've messed up my neckerchief.
Oh, sorry. I'll get you a new one.
It's all right. It just needs to be readjusted.
Okay. I'm just dabbing these little... bruises here, a little bit of arnica.
Oh.
Yeah, it'll bring the bruises right out. Might look a nice shade of purple.
Oh, gold. It won't go with my green outfit, will it?
Oh, it'll look nice, actually. Purple and green go together very well.
Oh, that's good then. Oh, dab away.
Yeah. Just checking. Oh, don't you mind you me, mister. Oh, bonjour. Yeah, I don't think you got any open wounds.
No.
Just a lot of bruising.
Just round my throat. I couldn't breathe. Yeah. I passed out.
Yeah.
Is Dickie all right? He can't get up.
He's getting there.
Yeah.
Poor Dickie.
He looks a bit fucked.
He does.
Don't fall in the water, Dickie.
Oh, God.
I'm thirsty.
Oh, dear.
Oh, dear. Yeah. Well. How are you, Dickie?
Oh, I'm marvellous. Yes.
What did the tonic do for you?
Fuck all, I'd say. I had a bit of an orange haze for a split second, and then
look at
when
you.
What?
The way you're standing.
He looks real tired.
He does. All your shoulders are... all hunched, like when we went on that boat trip after all that rowing.
Yes. Oh, I'm fat, mate.
Any blood?
I need to take a bite of something, I think.
Yeah.
Do you have any food? I got food.
Can you move your arms?
I've got nothing. Yes.
Well, I got some chocolate milk.
I've got some steak. Okay. I'll give you some steak.
Steak would be nice as well as the chocolate milk. Thank you. Oh, and a banana. Lovely.
Tell me when you're ready.
Yeah.
I'm ready for you, Alba. Thank you.
Oh, God, I've got no... God. I'll just have to put that there for a second.
Do you want something?
Well, no. It's okay.
Oh, Dickie, you look so tired.
I feel fine. I feel like I look fine, but maybe in your eyes...
Yeah.
Yeah, you look like, you know, you're hunched over doing something.
But, I mean, you didn't get blurred vision, so the ingredient I put in there to stop blurred vision worked. That one is supposed to be good for your stamina, but didn't say that.
Oh, we didn't test that.
Oh.
I haven't even drunk my one, but I'm still, I feel all fucked, so I can't really, it's best if I'm not feeling... tickety boo before I take drugs.
Yes.
How fucked are you? 50% or
around about that. A little bit, bit more.
Yeah, that's perfect because then we can see the real.
Oh, no, I mean just like because I've only just been helped up. Yeah.
I would say I'm on about 50%.
Oh, okay.
In terms of my overall health.
Do you want to give Rodney, do you want to give Dickie the bubbly red a watery red tonic?
Oh, gladly. Here, I think.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Mm. Had quite the cocktail tonight, Dickie.
Oh, yes, I've been shitting blood for weeks.
He's a much better guinea pig than me.
So,
stamina-wise... Yeah, he's more resilient.
Now, stamina-wise, I feel fit and ready to run 100%. Okay. But just my general health is at 50%, yes.
Okay.
What should I do when I take this?
You could run around a little bit, and or you could punch Rodney, and Rodney could punch you.
Okay.
Or, yeah, if you do the punches first and then run...
Yeah. Tell me when you're ready, Dickie, and I'll give you a slap.
I'm ready. Yes. 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 One more.
Right, that's enough.
That's enough. I would say I took a punch much better that time.
Okay.
He looks quite fast.
He does look
very... If I run with him, he'll be able to see, although I am still quite fucked. No, I can't run at all.
Oh, look at him. He's fast.
Yeah. Wow. Oh, God. Oh, God. You slid along there like a slidey thing.
Oh.
You all right, Dickie?
What colour was it? What colour was it?
Red.
Red.
And I... felt like my stamina, I felt like I could carry on running for much longer than you, if you will.
Well, it was a blood orange one.
I don't know if it was Rodney's weak punches, but I felt like I could sustain a couple more, you know, compared to when you hit me.
Even though you were only at 50% of your health.
Mm. Yes.
Mm.
Hey, look, try my hat on, Dickie.
And you didn't throw up either.
No.
That suits you, doesn't it?
That could be a sheriff.
Yeah, definitely.
Oh, yeah, look at you. You look fabulous.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear.
Yeah. Oh. Well, thank you very much, both of you, for testing those out.
It's all right. Yeah. Might have to have a few days in between these experiments, because... I can't go to work looking like I've been, you know, absolutely,
battered.
Yeah.
Mm. How's your Dickie Termy?
I think it's all right. You know, I mean, I was punching him and I didn't feel like I wanted to vomit, so that's good. Mm. And I have eaten, so, yeah. You know, I feel fine. How do you feel, Dickie? You don't look very well.
I feel like I could do with a couple of bandages or something, old boy.
Okay.
I've got... let me sort him out, because I'll get these for free.
Oh, can you? He's good. Yeah, because otherwise, if they're expecting you to get, you know, bandages and medical kits out of your own pocket, that would be real bad.
Well, yeah, but I'm not supposed to give them anyone. I'll literally lose my job if anyone found out, so...
Oh dear.
You know, I mean, I can do things like clean your guns, but I can't give you the gun oil. But on this occasion, I thought, well, Dickie, he'll use the two bandages.
He will. You've washed him, use him in front of him straight away. It's not long I'll sell him.
No, you look a lot better.
Oh, yes. I feel wonderful now.
Oh, yeah, standing up nice and straight now.
Do your guns need cleaning at all? You want to check them out?
Well, just now was the most I've ever fired them.
What, those two shots? You've not fired your gun more than two shots?
No.
Oh, well, you probably don't need gun oil. Dickie, how's your gun looking?
Does it need a polish?
Rodney polish your barrel?
Yes. Well, I applied quite a lot of lube to it yesterday, actually.
Nice.
But I'll whip it out and have a look in a moment. Yeah. Let me just finish my ciggy.
Yeah.
You just don't go off in his face.
No.
Oh, yes. Oh, lovely. Oh, that's a breath of fresh air.
I'd like to get some hay for Moonshadow, if that's all right.
Yes, let's do it.
Yeah.
Let me just whip this out.
Yeah, whip your gun out.
Oh, yes, it could certainly do with a clean-up, old boy.
Yeah, pass it over and I'll clean it up for you.
Sure you got spares?
Yeah.
I think it's still got two rounds or so in there, old boy. Be careful.
Yeah. I'll make sure it don't go off.
So we need to get some sugar cane.
Oh, blimey. That's in a right old state. Look at all the rust on it.
Yeah, there's sugar cane just across the way there, Luke.
Oh, yes. And maybe up to Rhodes for the
wheat.
Wheat, yes. Oh, look at Rodney. He knows exactly what he's doing with that, doesn't he?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, it's
got
absolutely
firm grip on me.
Filthy. I'm just going to buff it up now and give it a good polish.
Lovely.
Look at the way I rub it like that. Is that... Oh, yeah.
Definitely doesn't go off.
The right motion.
Good wrist action.
Yeah, got a firm grip on it, but not too firm. There you go. Lovely.
Oh, yeah, that's come up lovely, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, you've done a fabulous job there.
All right, fancy pants.
Yeah. Oh, I've got to get out of the holster now, and I silly ass. There we go. Good as new.
Thank you for that. And is that your own personal gun oil? Or
no, it's state issued, so I can polish it as much as I like.
Oh, that is wonderful news.
State sanctioned gun polishing.
Yeah, so, you know, always come to me and I'll polish your guns.
Okay. Right, let's make.
Okay, let's pay while the sun's gone.
Yeah.
While the sun shines.
Apart from it's not.
When the sun is shining, la 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 la. Oh, how don't much, kick me, horsey.
How much of each do you think we need to make some hay?
Oh, I don't think you need very many.
I'd like a nice stack of 50. Because I've got like apples.
Oh, don't tell Nandora to go.
Yeah.
Be gone with you, Nando. I finally got this waistcoat back after weeks of it being in those one of those dry cleaning places. Took their bloody time with it, old boy.
Oh, really? What were they doing with it?
Well, they were probably touching it, thinking of me.
Yeah, well, they're banter, weren't they?
Touching while.
Touching Dickie.
Cloth.
My waistcoat.
Touching his cloth.
Touching your cloth. Touching cloth.
Yeah. Get out the way, fella. Lead on.
Well, it's just here.
Oh.
Yeah, I think so. Is it? It's for the sugar cane.
Oh.
That's right, isn't it, really?
Oh, it's all that lot over there, is it? Oh.
You know, you can use just the sugar cane on its own to make sugar for your tea and coffee.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
All right, see. Oh, I see.
It gets quite heavy, though.
Yeah, you don't get many, do you?
No, one sugar cane makes two sugar cubes.
Right. So it's probably not good to give like sugar to horses all the time because
no.
It's bad for their teeth, ain't it?
It's better to give them the hay cubes.
Yeah. Is that a crocodile I can hear, Dickie?
Give that to my stomach, old boy.
Yeah, could be. Has your flatulence returned?
No, well, I think I've been okay for the last couple of weeks now.
Oh, that's good.
Well, you'll be the judge of it. Do you hear my stomach often?
Not as much as I used to.
Yes. I think I'm taking the right medicine now.
And your diet's improved as well.
Oh, yes. No longer shitting just water.
Yeah, I mean, that was awful, wasn't it, for you?
Yes. Yes, the stew was going in and coming straight out, you know.
Yeah. At least you won't get such high laundry bills now.
Oh, yes.
Oh, dear. What was making your stomach bad?
I'm not sure.
Probably a change in water.
Yes.
Oh, you haven't been drinking the water in Saint Denis, have you?
Unfortunately, yes.
Mm-hmm. Best water Dick ate is strawberry water.
Mm-hmm. And I've got 8 sort of pieces of sugar cane here. Do you think that's enough? Should I go for the 10?
Yeah,
I'm going for the 10.
I think there's going to be enough.
Oh, I've got 11. Would you like one of mine, Dickie?
Yes, please, old boy. Says the old fingers.
Yeah.
Let me just grab this last one. Thank you.
There you go. It's so nice that you don't have sticky fingers anymore. And,
yes.
You know, I don't have to keep calling you Sticky Dicky.
Oh, is that what you've been calling me?
Well, yeah, when he wasn't taking it off me, I was calling you Sticky Dicky. Have you got enough flow?
Yeah.
Jump on. Can you get to me all right?
Yes, it's kind of hard finding people in this.
Yeah,
it's sticky.
Yeah, it's very long.
Oh.
All these grasses.
Mm. Right, we need to find a wheat field. I know there is one.
Emerald.
In road somewhere. Oh, yeah, that's quite far away though. Roads closer.
Roads, oh, right. Oh, yeah. Is it by Carnegie Hall?
Caligula Hall.
Up by the Braithwaite Manor.
Oh.
Yes, apparently.
Careful, there's a pen through there.
Yes, apparently Mrs. Braithwaite wants an audience with me.
Oh,
perhaps we should go and see her after we've robbed her of her wheat.
Yeah. I'm sure she can, you know, spare a few ears.
Yeah, and a few bits of wheat.
Mm-hmm.
Look at this fella just walk along the road, mind his own business. I have to turn a blind eye to that. Good job I didn't see that.
Yeah.
Being a ranger and all. I know.
He didn't even move when he saw us coming.
I know, just minding his own business. Who does he think he is?
I know. Bloody reprimand.
Yeah. Oh, did I tell you about my friend Willie?
Oh.
Nah.
He's a recruit ranger. And he knows you, Dickie. He knows you.
What do you see me in then, old boy?
The boy with the tentacle.
Straight on. Mm. What so he knows?
He's from England. And he's seen you. When I told him that you're my friend, he knows you. And I said, have you seen his plan? He goes, yeah. And I said, have you seen the boy with the tentacle? He goes, yeah. It's my favourite.
Oh, well.
So.
Is he your friend, Billy, with a 10-foot willy?
No, I don't know that fella. Uh-huh. Do you know him?
Nah, I've heard about him. There are songs about him.
Oh. Mm. Do you know the song?
I don't know. Does Dickie know the song?
What's the song?
My friend Billy had a 10-foot willy.
Is that the one he showed it to the girl next door?
Yeah. She thought it was a snake, so she hit it with a rake, and now it's only 4'4".
But that's still very big.
Mm.
Do you know that one, Dickie?
No.
Are we at the right fields, are we?
No, follow
All right. But no, he knows you. So, I said, when you're back from Walmer, I'll introduce you. And you can, you know, meet one of your fans. Yeah.
And one of the young ladies behind the counter there, she came all flustered when she saw it.
So
well, you're very famous, aren't you?
Yes, right, we're going off road and we're going left here and we're going to start to turn now.
This weather is shocking.
It is.
I'm going to put my coat on when we get there.
Storms here or something else.
Watch these spiky things. Yeah. Is the panther around here, the cougar thing?
I've heard that there is one near Brightlight Manor.
Well, hopefully it's not around this area.
Mm-mm.
Oh, there it is.
Oh, the
weight,
not the
pain. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I wouldn't have said it like that. I would have said, fucking hell. Do you know what? I had 30 of these in my my locker and I threw them away. When we were doing experiments, weren't we, Dickie?
What's that, old boy?
When I had to gather weight, do you remember? Ages ago.
For the cookies?
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, you have to make some nice cookies.
I've got about 12 ears. Oh, my fucking Mortimer pestle is... Oh.
Is it back at the camp? How much are they?
$6.
Oh, I've got money. I've got $60 on me.
Oh, dear.
I need to go to the bank, actually.
Yeah, I got the money.
Let me see if this works.
Oh, yes. Yes. Make a note of how much of it you use. Bloody lantern on the horse. It might as well put a big banner out saying we're here, Stephen. Where is it?
I don't know.
Oh dear.
This is the fourth time this has happened.
Oh dear. Oh, sucked me sideways. What a pain.
Right, so we need to go into town, into the general store, and get a mortar and pestle.
It's really annoying because I had some in a. I literally had it a minute ago and it's gone.
Oh,
this happens a lot with my crafting satchel. I think there's a big hole in it.
Yeah.
I think it's the same sort of thing for if you do a lot of cooking.
Yeah.
I think that it's only got so much wear and tear before you wear it out.
Oh, I see.
So all those experiments where you was being ever so tricksy.
Let me see if Mandel followed us. Hang on.
Mandel?
Oh, that's handy.
Oh, she's got a lot of land, Mrs. Braithwaite. Wonder what she wants out to give her.
Well, could be anything, couldn't it? I reckon she's after your acting abilities in some way.
I had a spare one in my crate.
Oh, that's good.
What's the matter?
Divorced old boy.
What was you saying, Flo? Flo?
She's concentrating on her mixing.
I had a mortar and pestle in my crate.
Oh, right. Oh, I'm not picking up anymore. I'm just dropping them. There's three on the floor, look, in front of me. Someone wants to pick them up.
Oh,
Yeah.
So I've got a bundle of 30 and 10 sugar cane there.
I need to try this a bit more. I might have this recipe wrong. Look, I might need more wheat.
Do you like my pomaded hair? It's like gold, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a shame. It's real shiny.
It's a shame the sun's not out because it looks really golden. Have you ever used pomade, have you?
No, I have not.
Do you want to try a bit? See what it does?
Can ladies use it?
I think so.
I don't.
Okay. Oh, I thought it was for men only. It didn't work on ladies.
Ah, right. Do you want to try a bit?
Well.
Okay.
The ladies bloody mixing, Rodney. Stop pissing about with pomade.
I'll have to just give you that a sec. Hang on.
Trouble with people with full pockets is they were trying to cast shit off on other people.
Well, I'm a ranger and I've got lots of special things. Oh, for fuck's sake. Sorry, pardon my potty mouth. Just to carry on with your mixing. Stand over here.
I'm only jesting with you, old boy. Come along.
Oh, I'm a ranger and I have to have extra bandages and things.
Yes. Yeah, well, it's all worth it, old boy, because you never know when you're to be needed.
Yeah.
So where's the most dangerous place you've been to, do you think, Rodney?
I reckon tall trees. At night, tall trees, you've got, like, grizzlies, wolves.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's very frightening.
I can imagine it is, old boy.
Yeah. It's just the fact it's so woody that you just, you know, you can't really see where they're coming from.
Yes, indeed. And some of those rocks out there do look like the sort of size and shape of a bear, you see.
Yeah. So, you know, if there was a bear that lived here, you'd just stand here and you'd see it a mile off, wouldn't you? But the fact that you're in a forest and there's trees all around you and rocks and you hear the growl and you know it's really close... And it's frightening because you don't really know exactly where it's coming from and how far away it is. So, yeah, tall trees, I'd say. Big valley, I suppose, it's got its share of bears, but it ain't too bad.
What about the desert? Does that have any particular type of predators?
Cougars, mainly.
Oh, I see.
I'd say probably like the grizzlies are pretty bad. Like, you know, east and west, well, not so much west, that's your wolves round west, that's like Mount Hagen. But east grizzlies, you know, that's all your bears and wolves, that's pretty terrifying.
It's 5 sugar cubes and 1 wheat. And it makes, I think, 5 hay bales.
Right, so turn the sugarcane into cubes and then mix it with a bit of wheat.
Yeah, do you want me to make some up for you now?
Why don't we? Well, I was going to say, Flo, where are you staying tonight? Where do you stay these days?
I stay in the elixir shop.
Ah, right, okay. I was just thinking we could all go back to the camp and I'd get a mortar and pestle and grind up as well.
That's okay. I can do it here.
Okay.
Yeah.
You grind away.
Yes. I'll just enjoy my cigarette.
Looks like it's going to be a nice day. There's sun coming up over there.
Yes. Shame I'll be going to bed in about 10.
Are you coming back to the camp, Dickie?
Yes.
If you give me some sugar, I can make some hay cubes for you.
Oh, yes, please.
Mm.
Icky, do you want some pomade?
No. Why are you trying to get rid of it?
I just wondered if you wanted any.
How much did you buy?
10.
I bought it. 10 packets, well,
yeah. Yeah. Look, see how my hair shines now in the sun. Like gold. I think the cougar's over that way. I think it's that way. It's over. So what have I got to do with these? Oh.
Yeah, it's 5 sugar cubes to 1 wheat, so you don't use up so much wheat.
Right.
Mm. Yeah. Dickie, do you want me to make some for you?
No, thank you.
Oh.
What was the recipe again?
Oh, 1 sugar cube. Sorry, 1 wheat to 5 sugar cubes.
Thank you.
In your mortar and pestle in your satchel.
Do you want my wheat, do you?
Because they are.
Well, either of you.
No. Okay, thank you.
I got lots. Thank you.
You can grind your wheat into flour. Like 5 wheat makes 1 flour.
No, I just want to make more hay. 20 won't last very long on my jobs, will it? I'm always riding around.
Oh, right, yeah, I got no more sugar. I didn't realise we'd need so much sugar for it.
Nah, well, next time we'll just get like a couple of stacks of sugar then.
Does anybody want a copy of the news papier before I just throw it away?
No, I don't need it, thanks.
Yeah, I don't need it either. Thank you. I read today's. So the cougar's over.
I think it's over that direction there where I'm pointing, see? Over that way.
With the cougar?
Yeah, I know. It's sort of like there's like a road and it's quite near.
Oh, I've seen the cougar. I know where it is.
Yeah, it's definitely that way because it's not far from the ranger tower, which I can see on my map. It's probably not on your map.
Oh, where's the ranger tower?
Right. See where you got Bulga?
Yeah.
Blade. What, for the cougar?
Yeah.
All right, then.
Oh. And the ranger tower.
I'll take you there. Do you want to get your horse away?
Oh, yeah. I forgot he was still there.
Oh, sorry.
He'll probably follow us. He does,
yeah. Yeah.
He's very needy.
Yeah.
I can't believe how hard he kicked me when I... Oh, God, look at Dickie!
Dickie!
Oh, Dickie.
Are you all right? Yeah, it's quite a tricky fence, that.
Yeah, it's the angle.
Right, get your rifles out. Because we might have to blast the fuck out of this thing. Oh, part of my potty mouth. I know it's along a road, so we've got to find the road.
Is there anything we can climb on?
Yeah, there are rocks about. So it would be along this road here, all right?
I think
maybe it's too late.
Yeah, it's definitely on the right. That's towards the tower. Mm-hmm. It's along this road here.
Ow, what at the intersection of the road?
What's he saying?
Oh, I don't know. Oh? Yeah? Dickie's calling us.
He's saying herbs.
Oh. Herbs? Herb. Ow.
Right, it's normally like just here, apparently.
Is there a herb there?
Yes, do you want to go back?
Oh, okay, yeah, right, well, here. Let's get rid of the cougar first and then get the... Ow, Dickie. Ow. Around here?
Along this bit, I think.
Ah.
Can't quite remember.
Ah.
I know you can see it from, like, those wagons up there.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
But I'm pretty sure it's, like, because I remember the ranger said, like, these stones.
Mm-hmm. Oh, let's go get that herb then, if it's...
Yeah, I don't think it's here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Hopefully not. Where's Dickie? I hope he's not been eaten.
I don't know. Dickie!
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 Dickie! Oh god, where is he?
There he is.
Dickie! Ow.
Where's this herb?
Yeah, oh, there he is.
Oh, yeah.
Jump on, Flo. Yeah, she's picking a herb, Dickie. She's found some herbs.
Is it a herb?
Yeah, well spotted this hummingbird sage. Look, I haven't tried that one out yet.
This one is this one here. Do you want me to get you one as well?
Yes, please, yeah. I've heard it was in these woods, but oh, really?
Is it just the one here, Flo?
There's one just up ahead there.
That's quite a lot. Right. This could be right where the cougar is because there's a lot of blood over there on the floor. See it?
Oh dear.
Oh dear. Oh dear. Oh dear, that's not good.
But, you know, I need to find out where it is exactly. So, if I ever come this way, I can always...
Did you pick some of that sage?
Just the pink one I picked. Where's the sage?
Yeah, the hummingbird sage. That's what it is, yeah.
Yeah, I've got three of them.
Yeah. Oh, brilliant. I wonder what that is.
Dunno. As long as it don't make me throw up or shit myself, I don't mind. Well,
I had a couple before that I got when I came out here with Walter. And I never tested them.
Right.
And I lost them when I fell down the mountain.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I learned very quick to keep my herb pouch on my horse.
Right. Dickie's a good herb spotter.
That's what folk have always said, you know, Dickie can spot a herb.
Well, it's better than the other thing, isn't it? Have you seen Dickie? Who? Dickie the nonce?
No.
You know, you don't want that reputation, do you?
No, not anymore. Cabin up there on the right.
Is that the ranger one,
the ranger station's back the other way. Do you want to go to the ranger station?
Yeah,
can't even sleep there.
I don't know if you can get in it.
I'll just sleep next to it.
I think there is a camp just outside. That part.
Cougars live here.
Well, so they say. Where is he? Oh, there he is.
Oh dear, I'm deep. Any sign of the Kuguaro vine?
Nah.
Oh, this looks like a nice little house. Maybe we could buy this sometime.
Oh, that looks nice, yeah. Let's go and have a look. Let me pick this one for you. Here, Flo, do you want these ones I've picked up for you?
Oh, so yes, I don't please. Forget. And let me get Nandor over here as well, so I can put them on him.
There's five there for you. Thanks for doing my hay. That's great.
Oh, perfect. Thank you.
What's it like inside, Dickie?
Yeah, it's a bit run down, old boy, but it's got two bedrooms, a sort of living room, a kitchen area, lovely.
Oh, it's a bit far away from Strawberry for me, though.
That's true, yeah. It doesn't look like anybody lives here. Could do the clean.
Oh, God, it's a shithole, Dickie. Look at it.
Yeah.
Do you really want to live in this squalor? I don't think so. Look at all the plasters come off the walls.
Oh, yes. If only we had some sort of, I don't know, painter or decorator.
A handyman. Oh, there's some Kentucky bourbon there. Have you still got sticky fingers? Let me get it for you.
I don't want it.
You sure?
Yes, thank you.
Okay.
Yes.
So this is quite a nice room. Out of all of them, this is probably the nicest one.
Mine.
Whereas this one, just gives me the willies.
Yeah. I'll have that.
Can you imagine staying in here for the night with that cupboard there, waiting for the doors to open up?
Yeah, with that cougar outside.
Yeah, no, I don't want to live here. I like Strawberry better. Right, let's go to the station and then we'll drop Flo back. And then we better get back to Strawberry.
Yeah, you follow us, Nandor.
Right, I'll quickly show you where the tower is, all right? Oh.
My God, there's a giant squirrel.
What?
That's a frog,
giant
isn't
squirrel?
It?
Looks like a squirrel to me, old boy. And where's this tower, then?
You right. Sound more panicked about a giant squirrel than you do a cougar.
Oh, I've never been taken up a ranger tower before.
Oh. How exciting.
Yeah.
Is it big?
Yeah. I've only been there once, I think, or twice, maybe. But, you know, we just go there for, the tips.
Yeah.
know, when the locals like report people hurt.
Ah. Are there lots of locations where you can do that?
Yeah, all over the crossing. There you are, that's it there.
Ah. Oh.
Yeah, I think that's the place. Might be open, I'll have a look.
Oh, I was expecting bigger.
Well, there are other ones that are bigger.
Yeah, I think the one up in
Amber right now is. Yeah, it's locked.
So what's it used for, old boy?
Well, it's got like the tip line. So
tips.
When, you know, if I was here and I heard the bell go, I'd think, oh, it's a tip and I could go in there and check it.
Now I see.
So I know that Ranger Clementine, she's trying to get, you know, rangers designated to certain areas of the map. So, you know, there's always people there that can get there quicker.
Even it is for the swamp and roads.
Yeah.
Yeah, that'd be good because I've only seen the news hour.
Yeah, I could do that, couldn't I?
Mm.
The swamps, although I don't really know the swamps, so.
Well, you could learn there.
Yeah.
You could do some fishing.
Just gonna see where we are. Oh, right. I oh, know. We don't really want to go. Next.
I'm tired and grumpy and I need my bed in.
Right, let's just go to Rhodes and I can get to the bank, and then if you want to stay there, you can. No, I need to get you back, Flo, don't I?
It's all right, let's just all go to Rhodes.
Well, I'm going to have to go back to the camp because I've got work tomorrow. So you're all welcome to do what you want to do. I don't mind, I can stay up a little bit later. I'm not that tired at the moment.
I'm tired.
Yeah, you are getting like an old grump, aren't you?
Well, say goodnight to Dickie then, and then I'll go back to Saint Denis, maybe.
I'll take you back to Saint Denis, yeah?
Oh, thank you.
Dickie, come back to Saint Denis, and you can stay there, and I'll take the perilous journey home on my own.
You're a ranger, you can... Oh!
Oh.
No.
What are you doing? Why are you on the floor for?
You all right?
Naughty Monty.
Are you okay?
I'm down to my last... Have you got bandages? Don't stand there in case he kicks out.
Sorry about that.
That's all right. I was a bit wibbly-wobbly on the road. Don't worry.
I thought we were going across the battlefield to Saint Denis.
Well, I didn't really want to go across the battlefield. I can't clean my horse. I don't know why.
That's okay.
Just because of all the spikes, it's a bit dangerous. I was going to sort of go round it and then cut across.
The perilous journey home.
Yeah, and it's already started perilous. I was trying to get up this way, you see. He was going to cut across all the trenches and whatnot. Right, okay.
Oh, there's loads of yarrow in this field, but I can easily hear that.
There's no time.
No.
Dickie's grumpy.
Mm-hmm. I've got loads anyway in here. What's out there? Is that tobacco?
Yeah, that's all tobacco. Mm. Ain't it, Dickie? That's all Becky over there. Yeah, look, it's people like working in the fields making more.
Yes, I started rolling my own cigarettes now, old boy.
Oh, have you?
Yes.
Watch this wagon. Oh, fucking hell.
Oh. Oh, dear. What happened there?
Dickie got hurt.
Oh, no.
Dickie?
Yes?
Oh my god. That wagon, it didn't even stop.
What happened?
You're on the floor.
No, I'm not.
Now, Dickie's on his horse.
What?
There was a man singing a riddle of the rant.
I need to have a... Let me just have a little sleep round the back of this tree. Oh, to me, it looked like a wagon literally ploughed straight through you and you were laying under Monty and Monty was on top of you, dead.
Oh, lucky me.
Yeah.
It's too many drugs, Monty, that's
your problem. I think it is. I think it's... Yeah, I don't like the drugs. I don't want to do any more. Please don't give them to me.
Okay.
I hallucinated that there was just a man sitting cross-legged on the floor. You
know? Mm-hmm. All right, so your
hallucination is dickhead.
Yeah, I think we're getting some sort of like flashback.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh dear, too many drugs.
Yeah. Right, we got to go this way, haven't we, to get to yours?
Into Saint Denis, or you can go up there.
You're going back to the Emporium, aren't you? Are you going back to the Emporium?
Right. Yeah, the Emporium. Yeah.
I'm confused. Right, okay. I'm less confused. It was awful, Dickie. I saw you like just laying there under Monty and you, there was blood. Honestly, this wagon just almost knocked me off the road and ploughed straight in here.
Oh dear.
Yeah, I don't like that. Is that part of the side effects, is it, Flo? Or have violent hallucinations?
Apparently some of them do they? But I didn't think they'd be this long-lasting.
Oh, God, I can't be on my ranger duty tomorrow and suddenly have a flashback.
Oh.
I think I've gone too, Lally.
Oh, no. I just drink some more of that Gorma coffee.
Yeah.
Get it out of your system faster.
Yeah.
Or maybe take something that's going to make your stomach a bit dicky. And
no, it's dicky enough.
Shit it all out. Oh.
No. If I wanted to have the runs, I'd just eat a tin of baked beans.
Do you want a tapeworm?
No, don't give me a tapeworm. Don't you dare put a tapeworm in one of them potions.
No, I didn't put a tapeworm in one.
Right, good.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Apparently there is a herb out there that does make you super hungry, so I'm assuming there was a tapeworm in it.
Quite possibly.
Mm-hmm.
Right, are you staying here, Dickie?
Yes, I'm going to see they've got a room
in that lovely hotel.
Oh.
Yes.
All right.
Good night,
Dickie. Okay.
Yes, good night. See you soon. I've got rehearsals tomorrow, so I might not see you, but you're very welcome to join us at 10 o'clock.
Oh, I'm
up to there's full dress rehearsal.
Oh.
Rodney, be careful going back to Strawberry Old Boy.
Yeah, I will do.
Dark.
Yeah.
Wolves.
Well, Rodney. It's the criminals I'm worrying about. Yeah, nice to see you again. Thanks for the leg hug. All right.
You're welcome. See you later.
Thank you for take care.
My drugs.
Yeah, never again. Bye.